100 to 102.
Radio and CCTV.
And ho de ho.
This is Mike the Mouth Elliott. Hiya.
Hello, lads and lasses. Got some gobbing off. Got some spittle running down your tongue. Want your larynx lubricated?
Well, this is where you should be.
Classes, welcome!
Yes! To tonight's show of shows.
I'm juggling butterflies here. It's not as easy as it looks. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, wherever you are in God's allotment, it's time to settle back and listen to the best farting show that was ever on radio. Forget the pathetic rest. Anybody who listens to them is just a dildo without a battery.
Call Mike the Mouth now. 0191-477-2000.
Just when you thought it was safe to go for a holiday in Brazil, suddenly the sun's got you in a wheelchair with a stupid t-shirt and you're up at the Old Bailey.
Call Mike the Mouth now. 0191-477-2000.
It's got to be. Hello. Welcome, 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 everybody. It's Bang Holiday Monday here on May the 7th, and it's Century FM. I'll say that again. Century FM. As late night phone in, 9 through 1. The calls will cost you bog all. I mean, it's a squidgen of a tonner. Really is. So just pick up the phone, give us a bell, and lovely little Lord Ned of Ecky Thump. Hello, Lord Ned.
Hello, Mike.
Well, he's back. Yes, indeed. The bad is back. We'll do that again properly. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing yet again to the show of shows, the one and only Little Lord Ned. There you go. So, Little Lord Ned, have you had a very good time?
Wonderful time. Even the weather's been grand.
The weather's been grand, grand, grandiose.
Oh, it's been wonderful.
And he's dressed in denim throughout. It's denim, Ned. Denim, Ned.
Just today.
You are.
Today.
You're looking very, very, very line dancerish.
Back to the old collar and tie.
Selena, if you're listening, we've got a partner for you here. I'm telling you that now. Little Lord Ned, Selena. Line dancer par extraordinaire.
Selena.
Selena, she's a line dancer.
All right.
Just kidding, shit. So, you've been out dropping the census forms, have you?
The week before last, yes.
So, Little Lord Ned has been... Anik, people, all your census forms come from Little Lord Ned of Ecky Thump.
Well, not the whole of Anik.
You tell me, it was no running, that's why I'll give you the time off.
About 500.
Bugger me, 500, that's nearly Anik.
And if you're not filling them in right, I'll be back to see you next week.
He's coming back to see you, Anik. And don't, you don't want little Lord Nen to get upset. I had the census round at Nightgown Towers today.
Today?
Aye.
So that means you didn't fill it in properly.
Of course we didn't fill it in properly. Of course that was the intention, not to fill it in properly.
Why?
Because I just... Well, the question is, it says that the information is confidential, does it not?
It does.
So I filled my census form in and post it in.
Yeah.
So it's confidential. So how come somebody's read it to find that I haven't filled it in properly?
Someone has to read it.
Well, I'm sorry, it's not confidential, then, is it? And then she's told somebody else, who's told somebody else, who's told somebody else. There's five people who know I haven't filled my bloody form in.
District manager, he sees it first.
Ah, that's one, that's two, that's two.
He or she will check it. If there's something wrong, he'll give it back to the census enumerator.
That's three.
Who will bring it back to you.
And she's probably told her husband. There's four.
She's not allowed to tell
her. Ah, of course, well, all
do you think
your
husband would be interested?
Yes, husbands are interested. You've got to be interested if you want some nookie, rumpy pumpy. So it's not confidential. This woman knows all about me.
They don't.
She's had me form, she's read everything about me. How dare she?
Somebody has to.
Well, it's supposed to be confidential.
Yeah, but what real confidential information is in a census form?
It's lots of confidential information in a census form.
Say how much
nothing to do with this woman who's been given a filled-in census form to read at her leisure and come back to my house. Therefore, it's not confidential.
Well, you should have filled it in correctly in the first place.
It's near you saying that nobody's going to read it for 100 years. They're reading it in less than 10 days.
People have to. 10 years ago, well, we had to go back and collect the forms. I had to check every single form I collected 10 years ago.
Well, it's just not on. There's no confidentiality. I am, you send me another one out, I'm going to deface it, I'm going to crap on it. And then wrap it all up and post it back. That's what I'm going to do. How many others out, how many dare do that? How tough am I?
I think at the end of the day, virtually everybody will send that.
At the end of the day, of course most people send it because they're all thick. They're all thickos, you should always question the government. You should always say, write on it, why? Please give me detailed reasons why you want this information posted back to them and then wait for a letter back.
It's relative what government. I mean, it's a different government 10 years ago.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. It's not the government. It's not them people in Parliament. It's the bloody civil servants. They never change. Them buggers. I mean, so there's some guy, probably from Amsterdam in Surrey, knows all about my underwear drawer. How dare he?
No questions about your underwear.
Oh, so you've read it, have you? My goodness me! You see what I mean? Lads and lasses, I'm telling you, we live in a police state. Prioritise status!
Why do people make such a fuss about filling in a form?
Look, we do. Well, of course you should make a fuss.
It doesn't take long.
It's people like you who merrily, you know, filled in forms, voted in the Nazis, and then whistled as they took you to the death camps.
I didn't vote in the Nazis.
Of course you didn't, but it was people like you who did. Say, what's wrong with this balance? Just, they were elected, do you? Me? No, you've got to fight government. Government have got to be fought all the way. Like, you must never give willingly information to government. Because they misuse it. Governments always misuse the information. You know,
they don't sell it on to people.
Of course they do. They're going to sell all this information on to commercial concerns.
Not about individuals. Not about you as an individual.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter.
Some companies, obviously, they'll pass your information on because...
I don't want my information passed on to some tuppenny-apenny bloody company.
I had something once, not very long ago, saying our colleagues at such a clothing place, a well-known chain of clothing, told us that you may be interested in whatever, you know, it was...
What on earth are you talking about, Ned? What on earth are you talking about? He's rabbiting on there.
It was just advertising different electrical things, but it was a clothiers that...
The point is, it shouldn't be. It should not be that way. The whole point is, if it's going to be private, then it's got to be private. You can't misfill a form in and have it brought back to you immediately by a person who you've never met, who says, oh, by the way, this is wrong and this is wrong. You go, excuse me.
You'd rather be somebody you've never met than your next-door neighbour bringing
it. She's read it.
Somebody's got to read the forms.
No. That wasn't written down. Nothing was written down about reading. Who just said we fill them in?
They have to, and they won't be seen. That they're all right, mate.
They won't be seen for 100 years, and I hardly think the questions are going to help And we said, there's people in places, you know, I hardly think it's going to get them. I'm saying, I can't believe the government's going to go, my God, there's a place in Wingard's got an outside lav. Move in there quickly and give them a proper toilet. I can't believe it.
They must have a reason for it, obviously.
Well, of course, it's bloody typical. It's a smokescreen to hide the fact that the government have this information already. That's what the smokescreen is.
And lots of information they probably have anyway if they go to the local councils, won't they?
Well, they've got it anyway, of course.
How many rooms in the houses and things
like that. That's what I'm saying. Now, why can't I get what I want here?
Depends what you
can. Could you? Because we need that in a minute. Anyway, out there in God's country, bang all the Monday. Now, I know most of you's not going to be listening because I don't think we're going to have a big audience tonight because people are boogieing. It's a lovely day. People are out and about and enjoying the life and the fun and the parties and stuff like that. Maybe barbecues and stuff like that.
Probably fill in the census for them if they've forgotten to do it.
How can I trust a total stranger who said she signed a form? How do I know? I don't know, she might be the biggest guy. Anybody can sign a form saying I'll keep quiet. Doesn't mean they will.
You get yourself in trouble. If I told you anything, I'd sign these forms. I'd get in trouble.
No, you wouldn't.
I have to sign.
You wouldn't. The point is, nobody would know, you see. And you could just say, I never said a word. I have hold to my oath. But I mean, there's thousands of people. You can't tell me in the thousands of people they've got to do the census form, there's not at least 10% of them who are totally out-and-out gossips, backbiters and spiteful buggers. It's always these people who want to do the job. Not just you, of course. I'm not talking about you, Ned. But there are people, you know, who want to check on the neighbours who don't like this and don't like that. Oh, I don't trust them at all.
8-9 miles away from where I live.
Doesn't matter. Doesn't
I live
matter.
In Ambo.
You're
I'm
not a woman,
Annick.
Man. You're not a woman. If you're a woman, you'd understand the idea of pure joy of gossip. The pure joy of getting information on your neighbours. Anyway, I think we better do this.
Century FM weather with auto windscreens. For a clearer outlook, get straight to the point.
Now, I'm just going to give you tomorrow's and tonight's. Of course. Tonight's going to be dry. There will be clear skies, but the temperatures will fall quite low. The temperatures will be down anywhere between 3 and 5 degrees centigrade, above freezing, which is better than last night, but still a bit cold. Be some patchy cloud generally, but the winds are north to northeasterly. And actually, in certain parts, it could fall nearly to freezing, about 1. Anyway, imagine 1 to 5 degrees centigrade, 32 to 38 degrees Fahrenheit. But generally, clear skies. Tomorrow, well, there could be a chance of fog, actually, but there's going to be long sunny spells. But at early doors, mist and cloud, light variable winds, but a temperature 10 to 14 degrees centigrade. That variable, 14 degrees centigrade, you're looking at about 58 degrees Fahrenheit. And that, of course, is at, let's say, South Shields on Century FM.
The icon has landed. He's Mike the Mouth Elliott, and you can call him now. 0191 477 2000.
10 grand gag.
Coffee's 10 grand gag. That's your gag.
0191
477 5060.
Email coffee@centuryfm.co.uk.
Coffee's 10 grand gag
on Century FM. If you have an accident and then make a claim, some claims companies will take a percentage of your damages.
Ow!
Visit accidentclaimsnorth.com. What you win is what you get, which means whether we win or lose, you don't pay us a penny. Plus, we only appoint qualified local solicitors that come to you. And claiming for compensation doesn't necessarily mean you need to go to court. So, for a professional service that won't cost you a penny, call accidentclaimsnorth.com on 0800-855-855 or visit us at our website, accidentclaimsnorth.com. Taking your business, but not your money.
People that contact us are people who've got damn policies that they want to surrender.
The policies that we need are policies that are with profits. They need to have been running for at least 6 years, and the surrender value needs to be over £2,000.
Honestly, you can't expect to get up to 30% of the region's biggest selection of pine furniture only at the Pine Warehouse Sale Four Track Retail Park. People can visit us on the website. The website address is robinlloydassociates.co.uk.
Robin Lloyd Associates is regulated
regulated by the Personal Investment Authority.
Is there anybody there?
Robin Lloyd, the feeling that nobody's listening to you. People.
No one cares about your opinions on what's needed to improve the area in which you live. Well, if you live in the Winnebanks, Newport, and Westmill areas of Middlesbrough, here's a new deal.
Miss Milburn.
Miss Milburn wished to explore the outer reaches of her neighbourhood.
She visited New York, stopped off on Broadway,
the environment, and opportunities in the area.
Washington by nightfall, and it only cost £3.70, and she never left Tyne and Wear because Miss Milburn bought a day rover ticket from Network Ticketing, offering a day's unlimited travel on the bus, metro, Newcastle to Sunderland train, and the Shields Ferry. Throughout Tyne and Wear. Tickets available from most metro ticket machines, drivers of most buses, and network ticketing agencies. Where could your day rover ticket take you for only £3.70?
At Budget Windows, we build our replacement 3x3-metre Victorian-style conservatory is now from only £3,800 fully fitted and built to last. And because Budget Windows have never gone bust, disappeared, or come back under another name, it's reassuring to know you're being looked after by a company that lasts. The only thing that can't last long is our lowest price ever on Victorian-style conservatories from just £3,800.
Call free on 0800 449 444
or visit the show site at northeastindustrialestate.com and make the right choice.
Budget Windows.
Hey Mike, guess how much I saved on a new tire and quick fit?
I know, 5, 10 quid?
15? 2,500.
Pounds?
During May, police throughout the Northeast will be conducting on-the-spot tire checks.
The penalty for an illegal tire is 3 penalty points and a £2,500 fine.
Alternatively, pop into Quick Fit today for a free tire check.
Quick Fit. Quick Fit. You can't get better than a Quick Fit fitter.
Mike the Mouth with Blue Line Taxis. Order a BLT now. The icon has landed. Yep. He's Mike the Mouth Elliott, and you can call him now. 0191 477 2000.
All right, let's, here we are. Welcome back. El Bigzo, he's landed. He's in jail. He's down in London jail now. And, of course, it's all coming out bit by bit. The Sun has been part of this, you know, as we said last night. You know, it's about time, you know, if the Sun wanted him so badly, the Sun should be made to pay for his stay at Her Majesty's pleasure. All his food, all his upkeep, and all his medical expenses, because they're going to make a fortune on the paper sales. So El Bigzo, there's news, you can talk about him. Nationalise the oil companies. Do you know there's a boycott of Esso taking place by people who are interested in the planet? Obviously, this rules out truck drivers and farmers. And they believe that Esso is the one company, oil company, that has refused to believe that greenhouse gases and overuse of petroleum products is destroying the ozone layer and possibly the planet. Shell and BP actually are doing research into it. They know better, but they're a lot worse. They're not as worse, not as bad as Esso. So do you think we should time we nationalise the oil companies? We only need one oil company, and we only one. It's only one petrol. It's the same bloody oil. Whether you get it from Esso or from BP or Shell or Canoco, it's the same bloody oil. It doesn't make any difference. It's a joke that they've all got different names for the same product. It's a bit like milk, you know. How many milk companies do you need? You only need one oil company. Should we nationalise the oil companies? Take it off them without compensation. They made the bloody money. Sod the shareholders, bugger them, and let's just take the lot off them and say, right, you want to make a meal of it? We'll put you up for economic treason because you've been ripping us off. They are classed as the great rip-off merchants. Do you think they are? There's one another topic. And has religion cost you a friendship? It's amazing that you never think of it, but obviously you tend to think of it in terms of like the Asian lass who's forced to marry a bloke, you know, who she doesn't love or doesn't know. It's these sort of planned marriages, and that's religion. But it's actually, there's an awful lot of relationships for Catholic and Protestant, obviously Protestant Catholic, not just Northern Ireland, may I point out. So as religion costs you a friendship or a relationship, were you a fascist, a Nazi, and you lost contact with a good mate because they were Jewish or black or gay? So as your religion, are you a deep religious person, and you've lost contact with people because of your views? Well, give us a bell on 0191 477 2000. And just a thought, reading the poll, of course, poll being the operative word, I should point out, is that have you ever caught or seen someone masturbating, and what did you do about it? A strings per minor story I heard a while back of somebody dropping something on the floor, bending down to pick it up, and catching a male person at another desk masturbating. And they actually screamed blue murder and got the bloke the sack. He wasn't strangling somebody, he wasn't stabbing somebody, he wasn't shooting somebody, he was just pleasuring himself, he wasn't hurting anybody. So, I would have gone, best of luck, lad, just didn't make any mess. And I suppose women do it as well, you know. But have you ever caught anybody doing it? What would you do if you caught somebody masturbating? Yes, we've used the word many times. Don't turn off. If you turn off, bog off. Masturbate. Have you caught anybody masturbating? And what would you do about it if you did, if you haven't? 0191 477 2000. Well, we've only got one call at the minute, but I'm not expecting a lot, so you'll expect a lot of me going off, I'll tell you the name. David.
Hello, Michael.
Hello, David, how are you?
I'm a bit tired. I'm going to have an
all-in-it. Why are you tired? Why?
I get run down with something.
Bad form.
I've done a long sequence of night shifts, and I catch up on you, you know?
You do indeed. Don't tell me about it.
I apologise for last Wednesday when I was thoroughly boring after I was on after Patrick and all the anagrams of Ulster and all that, you know?
Well, just if you bore me, you're going off. It's simple and straightforward, so don't do it.
I won't do it again.
Please.
I'll tell you what I thought might interest you and your listeners, and that is about a week ago, both my wife and I both received in separate envelopes unsolicited requests to borrow money from somebody who I've told now I can't mention. It was on the bottom. And it says, we don't care who you are, what you are, what you've done, what debts you've got, whether you're a bankrupt, whether you're on the electoral roll, whatever. Doesn't matter who you've applied to and been turned back. If your pawn shop's knocked you back, you've applied to the wrong people. Phone us and we will lend you money. And I always read the small print on the bottom. The calls, they made a point of saying that the calls would cost £1 a minute.
Most of them are. Most calls are nowadays.
0906 was the first four digits. And calls up the 15 minutes to range alone. I think they're just sudden people about. I think they're
selling
one of these premium lines they were selling. I think it is.
And the bigger question you got to ask is, what's the APR? What interest are they charging? As far as the people willing to lend money, but it's a case of finding one.
They did an example that in the communication. It was 3,000 over 4 years, I think it was, and I think the state of the APO was 16 point something.
Well, it's less than some others. It's far less than some others, to be honest.
The point I'm making is, if everybody, those ads in the back of the tabloids and all that, if they've all refused you, who the hell, you know, and you've got all sorts of financial problems, who's going to lend you money?
Well, they will. It may be a scam. They don't get the full £15 BT, of course. Get a wadge of that. I think it's it used to be something like 60-40 to BT. So, you know, if it's £15, then, you know, what you're talking about is something like £3.50 for them, for Nout, for day and out, just for F1.
I just thought it'd be sad if there was a queue of people waiting to get through on the lines, you know, kept on 15 minutes to be told, I'm sorry, yeah, well, you're a bad risk.
That's guaranteed. But that's where, when people are down, people are there to kick them. And you've got, but there are better ways, you know. What I'm sick of telling people is join a credit union. I've still got to join one myself. I'm remiss. But join a credit union. You know, start putting a pound or two. Find your nearest credit union here. Start putting a pound when you don't need to. Put a pound or £2 or £5 away. You're helping other people who have been in the same boat as you, or you might be in the same boat as them.
So they're borrowing the bit you're saving.
Well, you see, it's a people's bank. It's a real people's bank. You put in every week £5 or £2 or £1, and after a certain number of weeks, you can borrow. So you can borrow without going to these companies. You're not be able to borrow 3,000, but you know, you'll be able to borrow to pay off some debt, and all you're paying is a pound, and you've got to keep that going. And you can help other people. The thing to do is, as I want to do, is start one now. Some earning, but I would like to put, you know, a bit away, even if it's £10 a week, and I don't need the money out, but it will help somebody else, and it'll keep somebody else out of the debtor's claw. We've all been in the debtor's claw.
We're talking here about the people who are truly skinned, you know, really hard up, hardship. And yet, there's the Bank of Scotland's just bought the Halifax, you know.
Bank of Scotland hasn't bought the Halifax. It wants to buy the Halifax, but there's a lot of legal problems going back to 1600 charters, you know, who was going to be the governor of the Bank of Scotland, and all of this, and what will their job be, and where will it stand in relation to the Halifax and his bill. There's a lot. They've wanted to merge to make money and save money, but they've forgotten that there are charters going way back 400 years that they've still got to reconcile. So it hasn't gone through yet, and funnily enough, there may be something written in 1605 or something like that that may well stop it. So it's nice to find out that the clever clogs, these clever accountants, and you should never trust an accountant, because you cannot trust them an inch. They come up with these ideas, but they forget the historical dimensions of, say, the Royal Bank of Scotland.
It'll cost jobs, that's for sure.
It'll cost jobs. It will pay out dividends for people who are saving with Halifax, probably. But the point is that what you've got to understand is that as technology develops, it devours certain jobs. The printing industry was devoured by the new technology, the IT technology. Banking is also being devoured by that. Ultimately, what they're talking about is that everything will be electronically transferred into an account. You'll have a card. You won't need banks. You'll just need machines, which will be refurbished by armed guards, and that's all you need. So there's
potential.
We've got Robbie
Coltrane advertising that cape. I know. Have you seen his advertisements?
Bartley Cart. just one of the most talentless actors around for a talentless bank.
Cracker, isn't he?
You see, there you go. Okay, David, all the best. 01914-477-2000. Yes, 01914-477-2000. And you kind of forget that. It's a very, very, very simple. Why is that? Big Brother's copying you, yeah? Hey, there you are. They're going to put cameras in the cat's eyes. Yeah, bugger of hell. Cat speeding. Why waste the time? Why have all this trouble with speeding? Why divert police time onto traffic? You know, invariably, majority of traffic survives and does its job legally, right? It might break the law here, break the law there, but we don't need traffic police. We don't need them. What we need is paramedics with a police function, and who can do, you know, who are mixed up with firefighters, ambulance doctors, police, and what have you. That's what we need. But really, we're wasting money on traffic. you know, let's put the motorways, go as fast as you like. Go as fast as you like on the motorway. And put barriers down, put some cameras up. Let's get police back to what they're doing. We don't need, traffic police are wasted, totally wasted on traffic, because the majority of drivers are decent people. They're not pretty criminals. You know, it's only traffic police make them criminals. So let's stop all this baloney. And let's get, if people want to drive 120 mile an hour, let them drive 120 mile an hour on motorways. If they crash, they're dead. And sadly, somebody else might be dead, but that can happen now. That's happening now. With all the traffic police and all the bloody cameras and all the road schemes, it's still killing people. We're still killing thousands of people. I always know that when I come to a traffic jam, 10 times out of 10, there's a copper. Once you put a copper there, there'll be a traffic jam. Let's get rid of the traffic police. Let's put them back into proper police duties. And let's get rid of all this claptrap. Put cameras up by all means. Click, 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 click. And automatic fines. Bang, right, we've got your address. We know they're from Swansea, bang. Or we haven't got it to Swansea. Right, we'll trace this one. And then it becomes a criminal investigation, which can be done by police. Do you understand what I mean? But the idea that we're putting miniature cameras in cat's eyes to stop speeders. Speeding is not the problem, chief constables and home secretaries. Burglary is the problem. Car theft is the problem. Car vandalism is the problem. Mugging of old ladies is the bloody problem, right? Drugs is the problem, not bloody speeding. When will they get into the bloody thick heads that the people don't need this? 0191 477 2000. Claire.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm
have
fine.
A fanfare. So Claire, how's it going?
It's fine.
Is it fine?
Yeah.
And your love life's wonderful?
Yeah.
Oh,
I don't remember when I was on the last time. About my dad coming home.
All right, I've got you now. Yes, yes, yes. You've been working away, haven't you?
Yeah.
All right, is he home?
Yeah.
Lots of prezzies?
Yeah.
How about you, because you're a daddy's girl?
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
I'm not.
Yes, you are.
I'm not.
Don't you walk you with me, I'll put you on my bloody knee. That's something your dad wouldn't say, would it?
No.
No. So what's happening then, Claire? How's your life? What's happening?
It's fine.
Fine and dandy.
Boring as per usual.
Boring? You, how old are you again?
17.
17 and boring. Oh, for God's sake.
Mm-hmm.
Have you got a bed?
No.
So that's your life's your own. Your life is your own. What are you doing? Where do you work?
I work in the town.
In the town, right. Why not get a job abroad? Work for a holiday company. Work trying to train as a air hostess. Go fruit picking. Go around the world. Hitchhike around the world. I mean, you know, there's piles of things to do in your life. You know, you shouldn't be bored with a pet. Have you got a boyfriend?
Yeah.
Is he holding you back?
No.
He's a drain on you?
No.
What does he want to do? Tell him. I want to put a bag on my back and go hitchhiking.
Yeah, I will.
Well, I'm sorry, darling, but you know, you're only 17. There's a whole life out there. Where you're stopping, you're festering in one place. Don't fester. Go forward.
Okay.
The world is yours, you know. Have you got any money in the bank?
Yeah.
If I said, have you got £1,000 in the bank, would you say, bugger off?
No.
Right. For less than that, for about £600, you can get a round-the-world air ticket. Around the world. And you can stop off and stop off and stop off. And you can pick up little fiddle jobs in Hong Kong, in Australia, in America and stuff like that. And you can bugger off. You're only 17. It's not going to change your world. And you can see life. And for 2 years or 3 years. Do you not realise?
You
know,
yeah.
It's your world. It's not my world. I'm too old. It's your world, pet.
Oh, really?
You've got to grab it. Then I just hang tight. And I think you've got the brain to do it.
Yeah.
If your boyfriend says no, well, sod him. Can't find another boyfriend. Might be an Australian.
I'm not bothered what he says.
I should hope not.
Uh-huh.
I should hope not. I mean, you're not married, am I?
No.
Let me see, he's not the boss. Just because he's a man, just because he's got a willy.
Yeah. There should be women ruling the life.
Oh, what would you do if women could rule the world? What's your first law?
Don't know.
Well, what
just would... get men under control.
Oh, how would you get men in control? Oh, we're a bit of a handful, man.
Because I can just think that they can rule all the world.
I know. Do you think it's the willy that does this? Or just the brain?
They just think they're bossy.
But women are bossy as well.
No, they're not.
What would you think, what would happen if men had had breasts? And we had to breastfeed bairns? Do you think that would have made a difference?
Aye, because lasses go through all the pain.
Got a bit of period pain's not going to hurt anybody.
Bit of pain, you wouldn't like it.
You've never cut yourself shaving, have you?
No.
Exactly. Let me tell you, you're going to talk about period pain when you talk about cutting your shaving. By Jove, is there a pain like it?
I've got a few men, if he's just got a little prick of a needle, he's probably cry.
No, we don't. We only cry if it's a prick. And I'll tell you this, you've never trapped your willy in a zip, have you?
No.
Exactly. You don't know what pain's like, man. Breath, babies is like constipation.
We cry over anything?
No, we don't.
I bet you wouldn't like it if you were on labour.
Let me tell you, I have been heavily constipated along with lots of other lads, and I know what it's like. Trying to get something out that shouldn't be there.
But pregnancy's worse.
Why? No, man. Women, you've had it for years. Women, you've had it for centuries. Obviously, you're just not used to it. You know, you should be... Men get used to these things. Women just... Oh, you're mandy, pandy, fandy, randy about it, man. No. I mean, you know. But what's the best thing about being a girl?
The best thing?
Best thing.
Don't know.
Well, I mean, is it having men chase you, or is it wearing all the girly clothes, or is it being able to laugh and cry and be a tomboy and tomgirl? Is it having boobies? Is it having babies?
About going out drinking with all your friends.
Well, that's the same as lads.
Aye, but girls have a better laugh.
Do you think so?
Mm-hmm.
I think she might be right, you know, because the lads I've seen today... The lads I've seen today in pubs around the area, by God almighty. I'm going to say it's a sad, the dinosaurs should have lived and they should have died out, for God's sake. I'm talking about archaic thickos. Frightening. But never mind. Anyway, what did you phone me up for?
Yeah, it's about, right, do you know where I live, right? Yeah. Well, I know you don't know where I live.
Well-ish.
Where I live, right, there's like an old people's home, but they've built houses for big families.
Aye.
But I like living about big families.
Yeah.
And I've got like little brothers and sisters and all. And when they go out and play in the street, the old lady complains.
Well, you see, when you get a bit out, you're 17, right? If there's a 6-year-old band or bands playing around you, they'll irritate you to death, won't they? They do irritate you.
Yeah, and all, but what's the point in putting children where there's old people?
Well, the old people seems to be there first, won't they?
No.
Well,
because they've just built them houses for the old people.
Well, they build, unfortunately, without thinking. But the point is, there should be somebody trying to get, you know, the old people and the kids together. But kids will always make a noise and old people will always complain. And no matter who you'll complain about younger bands making a noise. That's what happens. It's the way of the world. And, you know, what you've got to do, your parents have got to talk to your bands and say, look, have some respect for these people. Yeah, these are the people who've... The reason you've got a health service and an education is these people in homes, elderly people. They've paid for it. They've paid more than you, more than your mum and dad, and more than the kids. Yeah. The reason you've got all this is them, and you owe them a debt of respect. And the least parents can do is tell your bairns to just take it easy and be very polite. That's all your parents should be able to do.
Yeah, no, but they even complain with them playing on the little bikes and things.
Well, yes, they will, but, you know, there's give and take. There'll be some kids who'll abuse it, and there'll be some parents so thick that they don't really realise it. But these people are entitled to a quality of life in their old age that they've earned. And they've earned, and we have benefited from it. So, as far as I'm concerned, the kids, well, they've got plenty of time to play. These old people... They're on a limited amount of time because they're going to snuff it very quickly. So remember that. Some of them old people are not going to be around in a year. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So do you tell the parents of where you live Talk to your kids. Treat them. Remember. Try and get the kids to visit the old people. Make them presents. Draw pictures for them. Try and get a rapport there. It's the only thing is that these people, you'll find some grumpy old wrinklies. There's no doubt about it. There's some buggers. But the majority of them will be out of the moon. But if you know, if you keep it them and us, and remember this is, you owe them a debt. You owe them a debt. They've paid for most of this that you've got in this life. You haven't. Okay?
Right.
Champion. 0191-4772000.
The man with the golden gags. Never mind Pussy Galore. We've got Mike Galore. Sleepless Mike. Only with Goffy in the morning. Exclusive to Century FMs.
If clients contact us when they have decided to sell their with-profits endowment policy.
Would like you to keep
I would
the
say
speed
our clients trust us. The that's why Robin Lloyd has been in business successfully for you'll over 27 years. £60.
When you make the initial inquiry with us, there is no obligation at all. You're not committed to anything.
We get a valuation on a policy between 3 and 5 working days.
We can get up to 30% more than the surrender value for them.
Our customers are always giving us positive feedback and telling us what a good job we're doing for them.
The policy needs to be over 6 years old to be a with-profit endowment policy and have a surrender value of £2,000.
We'll refund the difference plus an extra 10%. That means you don't have to spend more
we have
on
a website.
Than you
the address
to.
Is Robin Lloyd Associates.
Robin Lloyd Associates is regulated by the Personal Investment Authority.
Robin Lloyd are the endowment people.
There now follows an important message from the Pine Place, North Allerton. Please, please, please stop coming to the Pine Place, North Allerton. We're
run
off our feet. Too many people are taking advantage of our fantastic offers. I mean, buy a pine bed and get a mattress free. Who wouldn't be interested?
Plus, storing mountains of paperwork in the office. £15 a square foot. It was costing me an absolute fortune.
The Pine Place on Standard Way Industrial Estate, North Allerton. 01609-7848-98.
The mobile storage you're after quality quick and easy solution to your storage problems. With containers starting from as little as £300 to purchase. We are the Container People, the temporary accommodation and storage specialists. Call the Mobile Storage Group now on 0191-584-1992. That's 584-1992. The Mobile Storage Group. Storage solutions for the 21st century.
I had a dream that to celebrate the launch of the new Hyundai Elantra Sedina, Durham Hyundai are selling a limited number at £19.99. That's a saving of over £1,600 with 3 years free servicing.
This is the worst case of a Hyundai hallucination I've ever come across. Next to be saved a new Hyundai Elantra Sedina comes with aircon, electric windows, frontal side airbags.
Transform the look and feel of your room with a minimum of fuss.
Yes. Well, you stay there. It's all in your head.
The new Hyundai Elantra Sedina is at Durham Hyundai Main Road Garages, Bramallgate Moor, Durham now for just £9,299. But hurry, there's only a limited number.
Basta, Helga, use the beep. I do like it when you use the beep.
We've had a bit of a delayed start to the flat racing season here at Newcastle Racecourse, but now they're off. Racing is back on at Newcastle. The first flat race of the season is May Day Bank Holiday at 2:25. The horses are champing at the bit, the jockeys are raring to go for a great family day out, and loads for the kids start the season at Newcastle Racecourse.
It's not about noise. It's about more variety through your no repeat workday. Variety. All we hear is the noise. Variety. This is the Northeast's biggest radio station. More variety on your repeat workday. Century FM.
Mike the Mouth with Blue Line Taxis. Order a BLT now. The icon has landed. He's Mike the Mouth Elliott, and you can call him now. 0191-477-2000.
Hi, welcome back, welcome back. Well, I suppose everybody down the borough is watching the game Man City versus Ipswich at Ipswich, Portman Road, Ipswich. Because obviously if Man City win, then Borough could be relegated. But if Man City lose, Borough should be safe, and I think it's just gone 2-1 to Ipswich, so it looks good for the Borough. But we're not talking about football. You can talk about that with Malcolm and Eric and Bernie Slaven on the most wonderful, wonderful phone in of football. Now what else, of course, they can't talk about now what else. I mean, ask them, phone them up tomorrow, Malcolm, Bernie and Eric, and ask them about the European directive appertaining to births, deaths and marriages. They will just say nout. But football, oh, they can gob off about football all bloody night. And you can talk to them as well. You can gob off for them on 0191-477-2000. That's the football legends, Malcolm MacDonald, Eric Gates and Bernie Slaven covering, well, they're covering the three main teams, but let's not forget the non-league teams, the North Shields and the Gisboroughs and the Pete Lees and the Blue Stars. Let's not forget them. And, of course, the Hartlepools and the Gateshead's and the Gateshead's and the Darlows, right? So, 6 o'clock till 8 o'clock tomorrow night, the football legends, 0191-477-2000, Supermac. Supermac, Bouncing Bernie and Ecky Eric.
Ecky Eric.
Well, you can't know what you can call Eric Gates. You know, you get Supermac, but obviously, what's a good epithet for Eric Gates?
Gorgeous Gatesy.
Supermac, Gorgeous Gatesy's and Slender Slaven.
He's got a hairstyle, any lady, be very proud of.
Slender Slaven, Gorgeous Gatesy and Supermac. There you are. All on the lovely station called Century. Anyway, we've got any calls, so it's madness. Now, here's a thought. I was just reading. You know, I said this first. Mm-hmm. Why shouldn't we build Wembley Stadium anew up at Tantobie? You know? Build it. Why has it got to be in London? Why has it got to be in Birmingham? Why not up here? This is the hardbed of soccer, and it should be built up here. And Tantobie's a perfect place because it's of a height. Unfortunately, as I said, I think you remember that we'd have to pull the whole of Tantobie down to build a stadium. But that's irrelevant. But I think Tantobie is the place to build stadiums. And of course, now suddenly all the North East Labour MPs jumping on Mike the Mouth's back. I'm just a leader. I'm an icon. That's my job. Good luck to them. And they're all promoting the idea that it should be built in the northeast. You're only 2 weeks late, lads, but go for it. Well done. And also, we've had a terrible tragedy, an attack on an off-duty policeman. Some spunky punk was trying to pinch his car and pulled out a knife and a screwdriver. You tough guy. Are you listening, tough guy? I'll tell you. Now, I'd like to put you in a room with this policeman when he's fit. And I want to see how tough you are. Wouldn't he, knife? Or knee screwdriver? No, just... You are a man, I presume. No, I don't think you are. You've pulled a knife and a screwdriver. So you're not a man, you're a boy. Anybody who pulls a knife or a screwdriver should never call themselves a man. Forget what's between your legs. You're a boy. Doesn't grow mentally. And if you need a knife or anything like that to sort yourself out and fight an argument, and you ain't a man. Remember that. So, I would like to see him sorted out in a private. I think that's fair enough, you see. I think a judge should be allowed to put that as a punishment. You will go into an empty room with your victim, who's now fully fit, and you are going to defend yourself, and he'll defend himself. And if there's no, no knives, oh my God, just fists. No kicking, no nothing, just fists. And we'll see how tough you are, you punk. Anybody who knows where this bit of filth lives should get him in, because I'll tell you, this gadget's so thick, this little boy, he'll kill somebody eventually. He will kill somebody. And if you know who he is now, and later on he kills, then you, well, you should just rot in hell. Rot in hell. 0191-477-2000. Oh my God, we've got a call here, my God. Is that Jean?
Yeah, hiya, Mike.
Hello, JD, how are you? Have a fanfare. No, I was going to give you a fanfare, but for some reason, Rod has moved all my faders down. Thanks very much.
I was just timing something, sorry about that.
Oh, I'm sorry, but you can't just do that. You can't just come in here and do that. I'm going to do another one. There you go, Jean. How was life with you?
Fine.
Good. So where are you from?
Wearside.
Oh, you've been on, aye, I know you.
Last night, was the first time.
It was indeed, aye.
It was.
And you were talking about Ronnie Biggs.
He's landed.
He's in jail.
How long for?
Well, I don't know. Who knows? He'll be in jail for a while. He's not going to be let out of a chooser, is he?
No, I don't think so.
So he's in, Nick, and he's been medically treated, which is what he wanted.
Yeah.
And he hopes, basically, to recover and get some good therapy, learn to speak again, and start pumping up his oxygen, and then get clemency and be out in 6 months.
Yeah, but the thing is, with the stroke, when you lose your voice, you can't talk, you'll end up, you won't be able to swallow.
Well, that saves money, doesn't it? If he can't swallow, he can't eat.
That's right.
That's not a bad idea. But I still believe the best deal is that the son should be forced to pay for his upkeep. It was their stunt. They were the clever buggers. They should pay every penny. Every penny of his incarceration, his medicine, his treatment, and everything else. That should be the son's responsibility until the day he dies. So
That's right.
We should tax the son, the Ronnie Biggs tax on the son, £150,000 a year. Thanks very much.
Yep. I quite believe that.
But you're not, you see, because Ronnie Blair, Ronnie Blair won't do it. Well, I'll call everybody Ronnie tonight.
Actually, the Northern Echo this morning, you know, the little funny bit on the front.
I've got it here, the Northern Echo, where are we at? Yeah.
Read it out.
Well, I don't think Ronnie Biggs should go back to prison. Why should he escape from going through the election campaign,
Exactly.
Well, I wonder, I mean, see, he must have been speaking Portuguese for years. I wonder if he can speak English. Maybe that's the reason he can't speak. He can speak Portuguese, he can't speak Portuguese, but give him a chance. I bet he's speaking English very quickly. Otherwise, how is he give the interview?
English. He can speak Portuguese, but he can't speak English.
Oh, well, that's not my fault. That's no reason to bring him back.
Nah.
But he's back, we're stuck with him, and it's up to the son to pay the money. And
that's
I would
right.
like people to write into the son and say, if you've got any morals, you should pay for the man's upkeep. You brought him back, you pay for him.
That's right, exactly.
Because they're a bunch of scumbags.
Yep.
What did you say about the son and the News of the World? Oh, they're nice breasts. Is that the son? It's a sport, right. Sorry.
Come on, mate, what paper are you reading?
Well, we've got everything. We've got the Northern Echo, the Shields Gazette, we've got the Hartlepool Mail, we've got the Mirror, the Sun, the Sport, Northern Echo, Daily Mail, we've got everything.
Magazine and Telegraph.
We got them all, you know.
Did you see Guffey in Saturday Night's Echo?
No, I didn't, because I wasn't here Saturday night. What was he doing in Saturday Night's Echo, the big punts?
Well, this car's been there for so long.
What car?
This Peugeot car, like, on the year 19, and he hasn't sponsored it, he's going to pay £100 for whoever's right when they collect it.
He wants to be careful, I might blame him. The bloody police these days, they'll think, well, we'll blame Goffey. He can pay for the bugger, we'll fine him.
Between last night and this morning, somebody wrote on, tune into Goffey.
Well, that might be Goffey, actually. But I tell you, the police are just as likely to say, right, tune into Goffey, it's your car. You're fined. He's 200 parking tickets, it's your responsibility. That'll sort him out. He'll get a rude awakening.
Do you think so?
Too bloody right, and he deserves it.
Oh, I don't think so.
Anyway, I'm going to have to go, darlings. I've got to go to the news.
Right, okay.
So see you there, Angie.
Right, good night.
Good night indeed, by Jove indeed. Yes, I have it. Yeah, I have it, Ned. It seems that the Manchester City have been beat 2-1, so does that mean they're relegated?
They're relegated.
And Middlesbrough are safe, you lucky buggers, I'll tell you the borough. I'll tell you, your fans out there, if you've got anybody watching you next year, you've been a very lucky team. Anyway, Middlesbrough seemed to be safe, and so the three teams were ready to fight again.
Join Bob Monker every Saturday for 6 hours of Simply Football. Newcastle.
Qualifies balling. It's back in the reflection. It's a goal for the UK. We're not, in a way, talking about Q&I. It's the press. It's club business. We really don't discuss club business, you know.
Simply Football with Bob Monker. Saturdays from 12. Only on Century FM.
And my young Jimmy used to love chasing the ladies. But then he started to get fat and lose interest. It wasn't right for someone at his age. It's time you changed your diet, I told him. Get yourself back in the running. He very nearly caught that young greyhound from next door last week.
Like Jimmy, with IAMS Adult Plus, your dog can also get back into shape. IAMS high-quality nutritional vitamins, everything he needs to stimulate the fat-burning process and return him to his healthier weight. IAMS, welcome to a new world of health.
Clients this contact us when they have decided to sell their with-profits thin down policy.
So popular, they've extended it to Bank Holiday Monday. Either buy your downstairs windows and doors and get your upstairs totally free. Discount restrictions may apply. Or get a free window or door for each one you buy. No limit. Just Tuesday offer that saves you the most money. Interest free credit is available. Subject to status. Ask for written details. And it's free fitting too. You can even buy now and pay next year. But remember, it will definitely end on Bank Holiday Monday. For your totally free personal quotation, call 0800-106-107 right now. Doing
for them. No one can escape the hole.
Still kind of shame.
Critics call it a horror flick with class that'll keep you guessing to the end.
It's a really twisted film. It's excellent.
Absolutely outstanding. And very
a fascinating riddle of deception and obsession.
Laura Birch is a sexy psycho.
I'm the only one who I see hiding behind my knees.
Just super scary, brilliant, claustrophobic children.
You feel the tension. It's amazing.
Messes with your head. Definitely go and see it.
The hole. At cinemas now, rated 15.
Inside.
My young Jimmy the tale of one of the Northeast's
most intrepid explorers, Miss Milburn. Miss Milburn wished to explore the outer reaches of her neighborhood. She visited New York, stopped off on Broadway, had lunch at the Hilton Cafe, and was home in Washington by nightfall. And it only cost £3.70, and she never left Tynan Weir because Miss Milburn bought a day Rover ticket from Network Ticketing, offering a day's unlimited travel on the bus, metro, Newcastle to Sunderland train, and the Shields Ferry. Throughout Tynan Weir. Tickets available from most metro ticket machines, drivers of most buses, and network ticketing agencies. Where could your day rover ticket take you for only £3.70?
Save you the most money. Either buy your downstairs windows and doors and get your upstairs totally free. Discount restrictions may apply. Or get a free window or door for each one you buy.
Because they don't take a percentage of your damages, or they're based in the Northeast and only appoint local qualified solicitors who come to you, not unqualified agents who only deal on the phone. Or is it because they only operate a no-win, no-charge policy? If you've had an accident or want more information, call accidentclaimsnorth.com on 800-855-855 or visit our website, accidentclaimsnorth.com. Taking your business, not your money.
We've had a bit of a delayed start to the flat racing season here at Newcastle Racecourse, but now they're off. Racing is back on at Newcastle. The first flat race of the season is May Day Bank Holiday at 2:25. The horses are champing at the bit. The jockeys are raring to go for a great family day out and loads for the kids. Start the season at Newcastle Racecourse.
It's not about noise. It's about more variety. It's about more variety. No repeat workday.
Should I stay or should I go?
Should I
stay or should I go?
Noise.
Variety.
Variety.
I don't wanna ride. DJ.
Noise. Variety. Variety. Is the Northeast's biggest radio station. More variety through your no-repeat workday. Century FM.
35 years after flying back to Britain from Brazil. A 71-year-old, frail from a series of strokes, was arrested immediately on arrival and taken to court. Kevin Murphy was there.
He was a frail old man supporting himself on a walking stick. After a number of strokes, only able to grunt a response to questions and constantly wiping his mouth with a handkerchief. The magistrate ordered his return to prison, but outside the court, a statement on his behalf read by solicitor Jane Waring.
He will seek a hearing before the Court of Appeal in respect of his outstanding sentence.
Some bystanders said he should have stayed in Brazil instead of becoming a drain on the British taxpayer. But for now, he's back in Belmarsh Prison. Kevin Murphy, West London Magistrates Court.
Police have issued a public warning following the death of a university student who'd taken a high-strength ecstasy tablet. 19-year-old Lorna Spinks died today after collapsing in a Cambridge nightclub in the early hours of yesterday morning. Ministers have emerged from today's special bank holiday cabinet meeting saying health and education will be the top of their election campaign agenda. They were finalising the Labour manifesto ahead of an announcement, possibly tomorrow, that the poll will be held on June the 7th. Health Secretary David Blunkett says voters can put their faith in the government again.
They can believe us because they can see those changes taking part. They also know that 4 years is a very short period in time to actually make the investment count and to change and make a difference to people's lives. That's why we're asking them for a full second term.
A man whose throat cancer was missed by 11 doctors has died. One told Stephen Harley, if I was your brother, I'd tell you to go home and get a life. 42-year-old from Barnsley died in Sheffield's Royal Hallamshire Hospital. Football and Manchester City have been relegated from the Premiership after being beaten 2-1 by Ipswich at Portman Road. Joe Royal's men took the lead through Sean Gota, but goals from Matt Holland and Martin Reusser condemned City to the drop. Independent Radio News.
Century FM weather with Auto Windscreens. Getting straight to the point with a service you can trust.
Yes, you want the weather? I've got the weather. You want the weather? We got the weather. Century FM, we've got the weather for you, because it's good weather. This is nice. Tonight is dry. It's going to be clear. There's some patchy cloud. Light northeasterly winds. Temperature, well, ranging from 1 to 5. On the coast and on high exposed grounds around the 0, 1 degree centigrade, 5 degrees centigrade inland. That's about 32 to about 37 degrees Fahrenheit. So, tuck it easy. Tomorrow, long sunny spells. A bit of mist and cloud at first. Light variable winds. Now, top temperature could be around about 14, 15 degrees centigrade. We're talking about 57, 59 degrees Fahrenheit there. But a bit chilly on the coast. But all in all, I'll tell you, it's better than the south. And that's good news for God's country. And Century FM.
The icon has landed. He's Mike the Mouth Elliott. And you can call him now. 0191 477 2000. Mike the Mouth with Blue Line Taxis. Order a BLT now.
Exactly. Why don't you just do... I could eat a BLT, I must admit.
You could eat a BLT.
Oh, I could indeed.
You could eat a taxi.
No, not a taxi. A bacon, lettuce and tomato sandwich, you know. But I know what BLT, Blue Line Taxis. I know it stands for Blue Line Taxis. But I can eat a BLT as well. Are you all right there, Blue Line? Send our love to Blue Line. God bless them. But we say now our love to all the taxi drivers, because you hope it's a busy day for you all. Hope you get any trouble. And if there's any dickheads out there, stop being a dickhead. Let the taxi do his job, pay the man his money, or the lassie's money, her money, and get the hell out of it. Don't vomit. But if you're a girl, you want to flash yourself, by all means, but expect to pay the full fare. I think that's fair enough. This was a public service announcement. Thank God. And the police stopped, I tell you, the police will not be bothering with taxi speeding tonight, because they'll need them. Yeah, Chief Constable, we've got your measure. We know exactly where you are. We know the shape of your spheroids, bunny lad. We know the shape of your spheroids. In fact, I can even tell you how many hairs. 0191-477-2000, Century FM, right on the button, gobbing off all the time. Oh, is this something I said, Ned?
No, I've just got work to do.
All right, I just wanted to hang on there for a minute, you know. Anyway, the car, we're not expecting a busy night tonight. Didn't worry about that. I am... Oh, God, I've had a good day today. I'll tell you about it later on. Joe.
Hello.
Hiya, Joe. Welcome to the show, Joe.
Thank you very much.
You're a rhyming person already in couplets. Hiya, Joe. Welcome to the show, Joe. You want to have a go, Joe?
Yes, please.
Hey. What rhymes with Joe? More, tour. Right, have a fun. So, where are you from, Joe?
Very good of you. Brandon.
Century Virgin?
No, I've been on a couple of times.
Sacre coeur. Well. Brandon, lad, right?
Aye.
So, what's the houses like in Brandon? I must say, is it a nice area? Could I move to Brandon and be safe?
Oh, very safe. Aye.
Really?
Just a... Odd occasional break in now and again.
Odd occasional break. How about the neighbours coming begging for a cup of sugar or flour?
Oh, they'll do that, aye.
No, I thought
they're very friendly.
Oh, they're very friendly, but pushy. I knew that about Brandon. I knew that about Brandon. So what's life treating you like then, Joe?
Not too bad, but I was a bit disappointed today. I went to a garden centre with my sister. You know, I've got a bit of prostate trouble.
Oh, well, what exactly is prostate? What does that mean? Does that mean you're peeing yourself?
I'm peeing myself regularly, you know.
Well, not really. It just all comes out.
Why, not really. It only comes out in dribbles. You know, you're dying
like after 8 pints?
No, after 2 whiskies.
So, do you have to wear these special, dare I say, incontinence?
No, it's not that bad, Mike.
You're not piddling in your underpants, are you?
No.
Oh, gosh, somebody's got to wash them.
You feel like you're bursting, and when you get there, you only...
It's a dribble.
Yeah, egg cup full sort of thing.
So you really feel as though you've got a pair of bollocks that's the size of Kayla Reservoir, and when you get the lobby, it's 2 egg cups. God almighty, and is it painful?
Well, it is when you kind of get to the toilet, like.
And that's prostate trouble. Have you? How does the doctor find? It is the finger up the bum, isn't it?
It is. Aye.
And
he
rakes around and he finds it, and that tells him just by him putting his finger up your bum and feeling around tells him that you've got. It's amazing, isn't it?
Aye.
I mean, see, I haven't got fingers like a doctor. I wouldn't know. I mean, just, when I look at my fingers, I've got to be honest, there's not one of my fingers I'd want to designate to go up a bum. I'd have to say I love them all. And I love you, lads. Don't worry. Oh, they're panicking. Don't worry, lads. You're not going up anybody's bum. Stop with me. There you are.
You've got to have long ones, you know.
I beg your pardon?
Long fingers.
Oh, well, you're all right. They've got to be long fingers. These are delicate fingers. These are brain surgeon's hands. So the doctor bends you down, up the jacksie, round, you got prostate trouble. You knew that anyway because you've got reservoir in your bollocks and, cup full in your dick. Right. So, what's the treatment for it?
Well, you get an operation, Mike. I'm waiting.
What sort of operation is it?
You're waiting for. They put a catheter up, you know, and then like clean it all out and bleach a little bit, and it cleans all the passages.
When you say a catheter, you're not talking about your jacksie, are you?
Oh, yes.
Are you?
No, not a jacksie.
No, you're talking about... catheter up there.
Aye.
It's a big... Women will jump on a gynecologist's couch and spread their legs up on the stirrups with the drop of a cough. But it's not too big. How does he get a catheter up there, man? Brings the catheter. So it's a tube, a catheter, guns up there.
Yeah.
And does that drain the fluid out?
That drains the fluid out, and it's a relief sometime and all.
What will be?
When you're busting and you kind of go, then somebody just turns the tap on.
Could they not squeak? Dear me, dear. I'm going to have to go to the doctor's. I'm going to have to get this checked. I think I'll have to have the early finger. You never know. An early finger can save all this, can't it? If men went to the doctors and asked, can you get a prostate examination? So all your lads gone out there and have an early prostate, it will save a lot of catheters.
But men don't do that. They wait till the last minute.
Now. I'm booking them tomorrow.
All right, Mike.
I'm going in tomorrow. I'm telling you, Joe, I've got knee. And I think all men, you're right, women are very, women's bits and bobs are wonderful. It's an amazing organ, the vagina. And all... Well, that's it. It is. It's life. That's where life comes from. But they're in and out, you know, they're checking, they're feeling, they're sticking, and all the fingers up and all of that. Men, we ignore.
No.
And we ignore our peril. So we should be. We should be checking our testicles for cancer.
We should do.
We should be having a fondle around. In fact, I'm standing up. I'm going to have a bit fondle now. We should be checking around. You should put your hands down and feel each testicle and check it. Just a minute. I'll get the little one down. And... just to make sure there's no lumps or out like that. Right. Now, you can't obviously test for prostate. I'm clean now. Now, there's no way... wash my hands now. But there's no way you can test for prostate and needs a doctor. So every man, get yourself, especially if you're over 50, I would have thought. Get in and check for prostate cancer. Check your testicles. Have it checked and you could save yourself a lot of bother. And there's no shame, no criminal, and you're not being less of a man.
Quite right.
So you're a dickhead if you don't do it.
Well.
So you're waiting to go on the operation.
Yeah, aye.
All right, and how long you been waiting?
Well, I've only been waiting for about 3 months.
So it could be what, another...
I've had other problems as well as that, Mike. I've had heart trouble as well. They want to get my heart fixed first, then do the prostate. Because it's not serious, the prostate, but it's getting that way, you know.
Well, I don't know. I mean, it's a bladder the size of a Keeler reservoir, I think, is a big problem myself. I mean, it's all very well the doctor saying it's no problem. They're not putting up with it. Wait. So you got it for a heart. Is that a new heart or a pacemaker? Or
pacemaker, right.
Well, I've got a mate of mine, Graham, down in North Tyneside, who's gone to the Olympics, and he's got a brand new heart, because he would. He's like, he's a show-off.
Yeah.
And, in fact, he's the chairman or the president of the North Shields Boys Club, Graham. Wonderful lad, but a show-off. Because he's got a new heart, he just keeps running everywhere, bragging. But it's an amazing things it can do now, so I think a pacemaker is almost like getting a tooth out.
Well, just the same. You're in and out before you know you're there.
You are indeed.
Aye. But what the problem was, mate, when we went to this garden centre...
Oh, I forgot about the garden centre. I was so busy with fingers up the jacksie. Right, go on.
Yeah, I mean, it's a big place. Tons of staff and that.
Aye.
I asked one of the staff if there was a toilet. She says, no, just for the staff only. I says, wait, what about the public? No, there's no toilet.
Basically piss off.
So I says, oh, well, I'll have to go outside and go in a corner. If not, I'll just piddle in front of the entrance. And he looked at me and I says, oh, no. I says, a place like this, I think, should have a toilet here.
It should have a customer toilet, male and female, with washing facilities. In America, they would have, and there's no excuse, and no matter how big or small it should have it. Mm-hmm. And whether there's laws or not, it's irrelevant. It is a courtesy service to customers. The people take the bands up. There should be a place in the toilets for mothers to change babies' nappies and what have you. And but never a place where mother's breastfeeding the toilet. You should never breastfeed in the toilet. Oh, it should be done wherever people are. There's no excuse, and
is there a law to that effect, Mike? Or
well,
what?
There is certain laws about
you demand to go to the staff toilet?
You should, they should be allowed. You should be allowed to go to the staff toilet. If maybe a member of staff will accompany you, but you should be allowed to go to the staff toilet. Any company that doesn't, then you don't deserve your business, or you tell all your friends not to go there neither, and they deserve to lose company.
Well, I would never go back there again.
Well, I think, did they not let you go?
No, I had to go round the back of the store, in a little alcove thing, and I thought it was disgusting.
Well, I would say that, I would write a letter to the manager of the store, post it tomorrow, saying how disgusted you are, and bearing in mind that our people with prostate trouble, or a lot of gardeners are elderly men, women have problems, need to go to the toilet. Generally, people need to go to the toilet. There are people with children there who need to go to the toilet. There are mothers with babies who need to go to the toilet and possibly help change their toilet, change their children in the toilet, and that they haven't got a toilet shows an ignorance of modern day selling technique, and basically a slap in the face for all customers. Well, and you should send that letter to them. And please come back and tell me what the reply is.
I will do that, Michael. Thanks very much.
And when you do that, I'll phone them up.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Thanks very much, Mike.
And best of luck with the heart eggs thing and the mm-hmm. prostate. I hope it comes out okay.
Thanks very much.
Take care.
Good night. Bye.
Bye bye. I'm telling you, all shops should have a facility. And if they haven't, if you've already got a staff, then you should allow a customer to use your toilet. If you don't, you're thick, because that person is going to spend money. I'm not going to spend money in your shop if you won't let me have a piddle. If you won't take my piddle, you're not going to take my money. Divvies. But also, you lads, remember what I said, check your testicles, get round there and have a good fondle around. And make an appointment with a doctor, go in and ask for a prostate, especially if you're over 50. But even your 40-year-olds, have a check. You know, and I've got to tell you now, whether you like it or like it not, that there are an awful lot of young men die before 40 and 50. Actually, the 30 to 40 is a more dangerous age than the 40, 50 or the 50, 60. I hope you realise that. So go in and get a prostate examination. And if the doctors complain about Mike the Mouse saying it, do it now. It'll save the NHS a fortune. It'll save you peace of mind. And remember what the lad said. You know, a bladder the size of Kielder Reservoir. You didn't want that. You didn't want to cather up your flan. Oh, my God. Obviously, women seem to... Well, there seems to be more space for a woman. I just can't believe it. I'm having a look now. And I just... Well, it seems to be tightly packed there. I kind of see a tube going... I kind of see it. Yeah. I can't. No, I'm sorry, I cannot see how you can get a tube up there, personally. Well, I mean, if you've got a bladder the size of Keeler, it's not going to be a tiny little tube, is it? You know, we are talking about horse pipes here. 0191-477-2000, Margaret.
Hello, mate.
Hello, darling. Welcome to the Show of Shows. How are you?
Better than I was. I was at Howarth on Saturday, and yesterday evening I was going out for a walk, and I heard you mention Howarth and Undercliffe Cemetery.
I've got the brochure for Undercliffe Cemetery in Bradford, and the letter was from a woman in Howarth at Keighley.
Yes. Well, there's a lot of tourist things in that area, you know, North Bradford and...
Is Wuthering Heights is not there, though. That's more near Sheffield, isn't it?
Pardon?
Wuthering Heights.
Oh, that's at Howarth. You're coming down, you'd be coming down towards Weatherby from Scotch Corner, wouldn't you?
Oh, well, I might. Well, Scotch Corner to, Osmotherley. Osmotherley's...
You came down towards Nedbury, you can turn off for Otley. That's a lovely little market town. And there's a very old cemetery there with a memorial to, The people that worked on the railway and were killed, you know, the navvies that built it.
Oh, the navvies.
The graves back to 1700.
Might be my family.
It's a very old market town. They have a market Tuesday, Friday, Saturday. And there's a lot of pork butchers and pies and a lot of bakers shops.
Oh, we had Jodie Ringer last night talking about June with her pork hambers.
Yeah.
By Jove, indeed.
And once you throw Otley, you can make your way to Geisley, which is Harry Ramsden's.
Oh, I've been to Harry. I used to live in Leeds. I know Harry Ramsden's.
And then if you make your way to Rawdon, through the traffic lights at Rawdon, and down into Applebridge and up to Greengates and cross the traffic lights, you will see, as you cross and go on to Harrogate Road, the signs for the Industrial Museum, which you pass at Ecclesville before you get to Undercliffe Cemetery.
Thank God almighty, you've got it all off here.
Well, I live in that area.
Well, I figured you did, Pet.
Did you know that at Thornton, the Brontes were born at Thornton.
Aye.
Which is only 5 miles from Howarth.
From Howarth, aye. But yeah, the Brontes are buried in the churchyard, in the church.
Emily is buried at Scarborough.
Ah, Emily's buried at Scarborough. The rest of the Brontes are buried in the church.
The house where they were born is open at Thornton. Also, I think you can look in the bell chapel where their father preached. And also, there's an artist coming on, I believe, at Thornton, and you can go and look at, you know, what they're doing.
Well, it's all on the cards in the summer, I'm telling you that.
Now, I've got you the telephone number for Bradford Tourists and Howarth Tourist Board. Do you want them?
Well, tell me, what's that number?
Right, just a second. Now, I'll give you the Bradford one.
Right.
01274.
01274.
7536.
Aye.
78.
Right.
And I'll give you the Howarth one.
Oh, the Howarth, right.
01536.
536, aye.
642.
Yeah.
329.
The Mem Saab wants to go in there because she likes this.
Well, that's why
the Brontes.
You went into Bradford and then over to Thornton and then on to Howarth.
Personally, I've never liked museums that talk about industry. It's like work, you see. I've never liked work.
There's Shire horses there if you have the children with you.
You feed the children, go straight on
to Undercliffe Cemetery and then drop down into Little Germany and Bradford.
Little Germany? What's that like, Little Germany?
That's all the houses and the warehouses where the German people, you know, that came.
Parachutists, weren't they?
No, the beginning of the century.
Right,
and there's a lot of architectural interest there.
Oh.
But, I mean, you can go around the ring road just beyond Undercliffe and then go out to Thornton.
Well,
and the cliff is the Worth Valley Steam Railway at Howard.
Oh,
and then you cut over through Harden to Bingley Five Rise Locks. You'll have heard of those.
Oh.
And then on to Saltaire Model Village.
Well, the Model Village, is that where you're like a giant and it's all tiny?
No, it's Sir Titus Tolt built it round the mill there.
Sir who?
Yeah.
Titus who?
Sir Titus Salt.
Titus Salt?
They're trying to make it a World Heritage Site.
Titus Salt? What a great name.
Well, the village is called Saltaire. And then when you finish there, you could continue to Shipley and turn left and go up Hollingsville and you'd be back at Harry Ramsden's and on your way
and
home.
And bag of fish and chips on the way home. Well, you're kind of going round. Margaret, that's a wonderful little tourist tour. Thanks very much.
You know, I hope you come down.
I will be down.
It's a very affluent area, that area.
I should damn well hope so. It's not getting my car tyres anywhere near
and
cheap.
And you'll find it's very busy. A lot of traffic on the road.
Oh, I've got outriders. Don't worry about that.
All right.
I am the icon, Margaret. Thanks very much, darling.
Right, thanks. Bye-bye.
0191-4772-2000. Excuse me. I need protection.
Join Bob Monker every Saturday for 6 hours of Simply Football. Sunderland
curls it in towards Kevin Kilbane with a shot! What a goal from Kevin Kilbane!
You get these things, you have to overcome them when you're not in the side. I feel as though I've been playing decent enough in the last four or five games or whatever, so...
Simply Football with Bob Monker, Saturdays from 12, only on Century FM.
The A178 at Seton Carew has a speed limit of 30 miles per hour. Break it, and maybe it's because they don't take a percentage of your damages, or they're based in the northeast and only appoint local qualified solicitors who come to you, not unqualified agents who only deal on the phone. Or is it because they only operate a no-win, no-charge policy? If you've had an accident or want more information, call accidentclaimsnorth.com on 800-855-855 or visit our website, accidentclaimsnorth.com. Taking your business, but not your money.
People that contact us are people who've got endowment policies that they want to surrender.
The policies that we need are policies that are with profits. They need to have been running for at least 6 years and the surrender value needs to be over £2,000.
Policies can expect to get up to 30% more in surrender value. People can visit us on the website. The website address is robinlordassociates.co.uk.
Robin Lloyd Associates is regulated by the Personal Investment Authority.
Robin Lloyd are the endowment people.
Or alternatively don't.
Make do with Bungie Shoe.
At Budget Windows, we build our replacement windows to last, because that's how we've built our reputation. With Budget Windows, you can have six windows from just £776, including VAT and fully fitted. Safe in the knowledge that your new windows come from a company that's never gone bust. The only thing that ceases trading is our lowest price. Come back under another name. Victorian style conservatories for just £3,800. Six windows from £776. Call free on 0800-449-449 or visit the show site at North Tees Industrial Estate, Stockton, and make the right choice. Budget Windows.
If you advertise on TV, this is how much you get. Call the tune.
Whereas on radio, this is what you get for the same amount of money.
Research shows that pound for pound radio can be up to four times more effective than TV generating awareness. So now who's playing second fiddle? Radio advertising is more powerful than it looks. For details, visit rnb.co.uk.
Over the years, I've heard some pretty lame excuses from passengers in missed flights. I forgot my passport. I overslept. The dog ate my ticket. But if there's one that really gets my back up, it's stuck in traffic. I've got no sympathy whatsoever, especially if they're flying from Manchester.
You see, a Reaver Transpennine runs fast, frequent trains from the north east in Yorkshire, right to the heart of the airport.
Arriva Trans Pennine Trains.
Let them do the driving.
It's not about noise. It's about hitting through your no-repeat workday. This is the Northeast's biggest radio station. More variety through your no-repeat workday, Century FM.
Mike the Mouth with Blue Line Taxis. Order a BLT now. The icon has landed. He's Mike the Mouth Elliott, and you can call him now. 0191 477 2000.
Well, should we nationalise the oil companies? Are you going to boycott Esso in an attempt to force them to go green with their policies? These are multinationals who pay no attention to electorate, you. They couldn't care less. Shell, BP, they couldn't give a toss for you. And they don't give a toss for government. Should we boycott Esso, for example, and say, right, I mean, say a boycott, a national boycott of Esso in this country could set it back £1 billion to £1.5 billion in a year. And that would put pressure on Esso, let me tell you. They ain't no measure about that. They're a greedy company. So should we do that? There is a boycott taking place. It's everybody is doing it, but the Shell and BP are being let off, so you can use Shell and BP. But I don't think they're any better. But this is the would you boycott? Do you think it works? Do you think it's worthwhile? Give us our answer on that. Has religion cost you a friendship or a relationship even? Well, give us an answer on that. And have you ever caught or seen anybody masturbating? There you are. They may well have just been testing for testicular cancer. You've got to put that into perspective. Yes, indeed. But, you know, what do you do? It's a natural function. It's a function that without it, in the sense in the sexual act, none of us would be here. It's pointless saying you've got turkey bases. I'm talking about the past. 1,000 years ago, they were doing it. The traditional way. We would not be here. And it's not a violent act. It's why should it be classed as obscene? Masturbation. Why should masturbation be obscene? What's wrong with it? Everybody's done it. Everybody's doing it. Some of you are probably doing it while I'm talking to you, you dirty buggers. But it's not being dirty. The point is that have you ever seen somebody doing it, and what would you do if you saw somebody doing it? Now, obviously, there's perspectives. Obviously, if you see a bloke doing it outside of school, yeah, you report him, you lift him, you get him arrested. You don't want that because they're children. It's an adult thing. Children shouldn't have to face that from any direction. But, you know, it seems that there have been more and more reports of people being caught masturbating. It seems it's an activity that may be on the up. So, what would you do? What would you do? And don't be embarrassed by it. Masturbation is a totally normal, natural thing. It doesn't turn you blind. It is not a sin. It is not something that is going to spoil your sex life. And no matter, even if you never have a rumpy pumpy, it's still not going to spoil your sex life. It's a totally natural thing for men and for women. And for women. Love balls, by Joe. Vibrators, you name it. There are machines and functions for men and women. But usually it all comes down to your five knuckle friend. But have you seen somebody masturbating? Talk to me on 0191 477 2000. Jordy.
Hello, mate.
Oh, Jordy, my boy, fanfare. Well, Jordy, you, by Jove, you look as though you just come out of the shower.
Who's this Albert Einstein? It's called me a divvy.
Albert Einstein never goes to a divvy, has he? When did he do that, like?
No, like last night.
Oh, no, I put him right. I put him right very quickly. Obviously, I mean, you see, he doesn't realise that, you know Albert Einstein, chief brewer, S&M.
What's he got? Any Nobel Prize?
Oh, no, he's got... I think he had a, I think he had a bad vasectomy. I think he's got the no nob prize. So what's you bouncy, you you're a bit like a boxer ready to go in the ring. You know what I mean? Ooh, ooh, ooh. So you had a good day, son. Bank holiday?
Well, yeah. Walking all day.
Not in the garden?
Well, yeah, just doing me neighbours, yeah.
Oh, Jones?
Yeah, yeah.
How's she get on with the hampers, with the pork?
Oh, right, she got them all sorted out there.
I need to find out the price, you know, and what's the contents. I'm still waiting for that. You know,
I'll ask her.
And so you've been off the summer bluching?
Huh?
You've been off the bluching?
Oh, I'm on it. On the cans, yeah.
On the cans? Oh. So what are you drinking? What? Do you know Miller Lite has got no carbohydrates? Did you know that? Just a thought if you want to lose weight.
I haven't got any weight to lose.
There you are. How thin, what do you wear like?
Blue 8.5 stone, wearing clothes, man.
And how tall are you?
Good 5'8".
5'8", by God almighty, like Alec Guinness in the bridge on the River Kwai, aren't you?
Well, there's plenty of walking, is there?
It always struck me, the bridge on the River Kwai, that supposedly were suffering so badly without any lime and rickets and gum disease, but they could all whistle. I could never understand how they could whistle so well, you know.
I see they got a hold of me mate.
Oh, Bigsy.
Caught up with him.
Aye, Bigsy's in the banger.
Yeah, it's a pretty...
What, you want them released, yeah?
Right, it's a pretty force, sir.
Well, it's not. I mean, he should have stopped in bloody Brazil and died there. That's where he wanted to live. Should have lived and died there. What the hell's he doing? Come back here?
Well, he works bloody...
He's a criminal, man, Jody Rinker. He's a criminal. He's a thief. He stole money. He helped batter a bloke. He's broke out of jail. I think them three just, you know, if it was somebody who broke into your house, battered you, and then broke out of jail, and then you wouldn't be saying, oh, let him go. You'd be saying, hang the bugger.
wouldn't batter me like that, so now I've got a big stick to me, brother.
but what happens if you were on the lavvy when he came in and he jumped you when you were in middle flush? I meant to say you couldn't defend yourself. You've got a toilet roll in one hand, a sheaf of paper in the other hand, and he's coming at you with a brick. You're finished.
Aye.
I mean, you say criminals didn't play fair, you know, Jody Rinker. So, hey, you sound fresh, though. You sound as though you would put a full day's work in with that neighbour, June.
The poor bloke's like, 70 and I,
Is this bad when you talk? Did it come up with a wrinkly talk? I'm not bothered with wrinkly. I'm 71! Bugger him, he's a bloody train robber. If he's thick, he deserves to be in prison. If he'd stopped in jail, all the rest were out after 10 and 15 years. He would have been out for 20 years, man.
Aye, well, he got a word, didn't he?
Ah, but he could have been living for 20 years. You know, God almighty, the man's a dipstick.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, I know you don't know. That's why I'm here, Jody Rinker Home.
Is there any compassion?
I've got any compassion for him. No! He stole my money. I was only a boy at the time, you know.
Well, yeah, I mean,
1963, great train robbery. What was the crossing that stopped at? Where? Not many people remember. I've just gone out of my bloody mind now. I just had it. I mean, talking me tongue, my tongue. Something crossing. Sutter's crossing? No, I forget the name.
That's
the way
they made
a firm,
didn't
they? Aye. It's a great train. It was called the Great Train Robbery. It was called Robbery. Stanley Baker.
Was that the one with Phil Collins in?
No, that was called Buster.
Oh, Buster.
Aye, he's dead. He hung his cell, him. We used to sell flowers outside of Waterloo. I've taught him. I bought some flowers off him once. Canny flowers. Can I complain about the flowers I bought?
You know what you were about before, ain't you? About people masturbating there.
Aye.
What would you do, if you caught anybody here?
Well, I would just say good on you and walk away.
Depends if it was a woman or a man now.
If it was a woman, I would say enjoy yourself, pet. Do you want a hand?
Well, yeah. If it was a bloke, I'd have me Sancho's on that.
Is there any specific reason? Because there's only you, Jody Rinker, would enter Rinker Sancho's. Not trainers, I know. So what, you do a runner?
You're damn right, I would.
And we say, what happens if somebody came up to you and had both arms in plaster, both legs in plaster, and said, Johnny Ringer, would you masturbate me because I'm desperate?
Aye.
Would you help him out?
No, I wouldn't.
Where's the good Samaritan in you? You know, where is help thy neighbour, love thy neighbour as thyself?
Who can get a woman to do it?
it'd be nice, but what would you do if you're at work, you drop your pen, you bend under the desk, and you saw somebody on the other side having a bit fumble and rumble? What would you do? Would you report them, or would you ignore them, or would you go, I'm watching you? Go on, keep on it.
I don't know, I think I'd look the other way.
You'd look the other way? Well, that's obvious, isn't it? Did you turn round and face them? Were you back to them? Yeah, there's nothing wrong with it, man, Geordie. It's not a mortal sin. It's all had garbage.
I'm not...
I'll admit it, Geordie. You've masturbated, haven't you?
Well, aye.
I thought so. You see, I'm never wrong.
Hasn't everybody?
Pardon?
Hasn't everybody?
No, I haven't. I've kept my seat to myself. That's why I've got such a big belly. When mine comes out, by God, it could populate Africa.
I made love to you that night. It was very nice.
Oh, I bet it was. Anybody you knew?
Huh?
Anybody you know?
I'm my wife.
Oh, lovely, lovely. It's always better to have a face under you recognised, isn't it?
Hold on, Linker. I've been married for 17 years. I haven't been anywhere.
I should hope not. I don't think there's any reason for a man. If a man doesn't fancy his wife, he should finish with her and then find another woman. I'm a big anti-adultery man. Don't believe in it. I think it's cowardice. Selfish. Greedy. No.
No, she's a good-looking woman.
I bet she is. I've always said to every woman I've lived with, excuse me, darling, I'm going out to commit adultery. I've always said that. And I think I feel better for it. I feel better for it. I think you've got to be honest. Be true to thyself as a man. Oh, who said that? Shakespeare, I think.
No, I don't know like that.
No, and I think you stand head and shoulders above other men who have, because I think you should be proud of that. Because that's the woman you've picked, that's the woman you've promised yourself to.
No, I wouldn't do that.
I'm sure you, I know you wouldn't, Johnny. I know. That underneath that rough, bluff, summer blutching exterior, there is a decent, honest man.
Well,
women are like that. It's called PMT. And we've just got to put... We've got to smile. When they hit you with a hammer, you're going, ha! PMT, pet! Have a Malteser. They reckon Maltesers are very good. Chocolate's very good. If your wife's got PMT, get them chocolate. Yeah, you might have to hold them down for the first 5 minutes and force feed them. But after they've got a good mouthful, they calm down.
Well, I found. She's been in a bad mood since
you
come in.
She's been with your daughter, sir. Oh, well, your daughter will be winding her up, man. Daughters are like that, man, warning and whinging on these modern daughters, you know, blaming men for the whole bloody troubles of the world. Their period pains, their PMT, having babies, oh, God. We're all to blame, man. We've done out. All we've done is took them out, bought them dinner, bought them some flowers and had a shag. God almighty, is that a lot?
Start picking on us right now, because I
walk
on the floor
later. Oh, well, they didn't like you walking on the floor. I've noticed that about women.
I think, she had just washed it.
I know, but they say, is that you walking on my floor? And they say, we else? I mean, say, somebody else's legs have took over my body. Oh, the funny man they are. No. Oh, no, you've just got to smile at them. Always smile at them and say, yes, dear, I do apologise. You're right. Always accept the fact that she's right, you're wrong.
No.
You don't have to believe it, Jody. You don't have to believe it. Just see it.
She got the answer, she's been in a bad mood since she come in, and she wants to get off my back.
Ooh, that's not the answer. That's not the right answer. That just works them up, man. That gives them a grudge and a grievance. Just say, I'm sorry, darling, I wasn't thinking. How thoughtless of me. I'm such a male pig. I shall go out and cut my willy off just to please you. Something like that. That keeps them happy. Because they know you're not going to cut your willy off, but they like the fact that you've offered. Oh, the funny creatures, women. Thank heaven. For little girls. They grow up in the most amusing way.
Sure, you think you got what he deserved?
Aye?
You think you got what he deserved?
Who? Oh, Briggsy, well, yeah, we don't know what he gets here to. He's in a prison hospital getting assessed.
I never hold it like all us. Feels like they've gotten Ronnie Briggs.
Well, they haven't gotten him. He's give himself up. I might say the Scotland Yard wouldn't even pay for 2 airfares to get across and get him.
But, well, like you was saying, like, was it last night there?
Aye.
What's it going to cost to keep them in there?
About, it's reckoned now, they're talking about anywhere between 60 and 120,000 pounds a year. For all the medical help. All the special medical care, special bed, special exercise, special therapy, voice therapy, stroke therapy, tests, diddly, 24-hour care, about 100, maybe 100,000 a year. And the son should pay it. But you should all write to Tony Blair and demand that the son pay for all of the costs. They wanted to do it, that's their stunt, they should pay for it.
So what's the point of locking him up, if it's going to cost that much?
Well, actually, you didn't need to lock him up because he's had his strokes and he can hardly talk, so he's not going to go anywhere, is he? You know, he's not going to go anywhere. Mind, he has come from Brazil, so he's not that daft. He's getting free treatment here. It would have cost him a fortune. It would have bankrupted his family if he'd stopped in Brazil. This way, the son are paying money out, allegedly, I've got to say that, to his family in Brazil and others. And this way, his family don't have to pay the costs. We have to pay the costs.
Well, yeah, I can see your point
there. Personally, I think they should tuck him in and just fill an hypodermic and whip a pile of morphine in and snuff him out now. It's the quickest way. Just get rid of him now.
Yeah.
Kill him.
No, I think
not. Kill him, man. Just bump. All you need is... Oh, my God. Come down off the ceiling, Mr. Biggs. We'll give you too much. Deed. Snuffed it. Bye-bye. Buried. Simple, done, dusted.
No, I think I've got too much room in neck.
You got too much room in neck?
Well, yeah. I've got too much room in neck, like, what a thing like that.
No. You've got to be hard and cruel. That's why I'd be a good Prime Minister. That's because I would kill people. Anybody who crossed me would get the needle.
Aye, no, they would.
Well, they would. Not you, Geordie, but anybody else. I've got me list. I have my list, Geordie. If I was Prime Minister, you'd come in and say, you're not going to do it? Sit down on that needle. Up the jacksy. Thank you. Put him in the bin.
I'll work for you, son.
You'd have a job for me. I didn't mind. And I didn't mind drinkers. You know, what is it, Shakespeare, you said? Have me around me with fat men. Surround me with fat men, for I can trust them. That's what you need. Because fat men are wonderful. Fat men are grand. There's something nice to cuddle just in between times. Stick to a fat man and you'll never have a lean time. Fat men are nice to know, and you can't count him on also ran. A lady and a little boy with me sat in the train. The little boy looked up at me and said in such a gentle refrain, oh, tell me, Michael, if you bounce, do you bounce up again? Cheeky booger. You can't beat a nice fat man. Oh, chicken now. Sorry about that. Just moving on. Geordie, I got to go.
All right, mate.
All together now. Fat men are wonderful.
Join Bob Marker every Saturday for 6 hours of Simply Football. Middlesbrough.
Phil Neville. He's got to the edge of the Middlesbrough area. And tries to shot. What a goal from Phil Neville.
We've still got a 4-point and a 5-point gap. So it's in our own hands. And next week, what we've got to do is finish the job off next week.
Simply Football with Bob Monker. Saturdays from 12. Only on Century FM.
At the Baltimore Studio, we're confident that you'll find a huge choice of exclusive designs you simply won't find anywhere else.
certain that you'll find the bathroom of your dreams for less.
Hello,
and right now, there are even more reasons to choose the Bathroom Studio. Because for a limited period, when you purchase a new bathroom suite from selected ranges, you'll receive a superb matching bath.
I want to talk to a solicitor about my campaign.
Can you imagine a more beautiful way to realize your dream?
With a free bath, your dream bathroom is now even more affordable from the Bathroom Studio. Linthorpe Road, Middlesbrough, Kingston Park, Newcastle, and Giles Gate, Durham.
Down and come and talk to the nice lady. We've had a bit of a delayed start to the flat racing season here at Newcastle Racecourse, but now they're off. Racing is back on at Newcastle. The first flat race of the season is May Day Bank Holiday at 2:25. The horses are champing at the bit. The jockeys are raring to go for a great family day out, and loads for the kids start the season at Newcastle Racecourse.
Right. Due to popular demand,
Nixon's Kitchens are now giving you a second chance to save an incredible 20%. That's right. 20% off a quality Nixon's Kitchen. What's more, when you place your order, we'll give you a free oven and hob. But you'll have to hurry. This offer is strictly limited. So if you want to save a massive 20% on a quality Nixon's Kitchen and receive a free oven and hob, hurry down to our Seaton Burn showroom. Call 08000 28 27 28.
The art of kitchen design. Nixon's Kitchen. Art of kitchen design.
The cameras are watching you. Break the speed
at
limit
the budget
and
windows, a new 3x3 metre Victorian-style conservatory is now from only £3,800 fully fitted and built to last. And because budget windows have never gone bust, disappeared or come back under another name, it's reassuring to know you're being looked after by a company that lasts. The only thing that can't last long is our lowest price ever on Victorian-style conservatories from just £3,800.
Call free on 0800 449 449
or visit the show site at North Tees Industrial Estate, Stockton, and make the right choice. Budget windows.
Bedroom furniture, stylish if it wasn't for the name, you'd hardly recognise the place.
Because Shaw Garden Centre has had a serious makeover. It's bigger, with trees, shrubs, conservatory furniture and garden accessories. It's better, with an extensive range of giftware, stylish stone ornaments, terracotta pots and paving. It's beautiful, with tropical fish, aquatic centre, Interflora florist, and a stunning new coffee shop for delicious hot and cold snacks. But best of all, Shaw Garden Centre still offer fantastic value for money. So why not put the new look Shaw Garden Centre at the top of your shopping list this Bank Holiday weekend? Shaw Garden Centre, Station Road, Cramlington. Shaw, it's the one you're looking for.
He's bald, but he's bald, he's bald,
he's bald, but you're all mad.
From Relay to the Lone Ranger, as his captain covers a door, Tonto had his
making the Northeast laugh on the way home. Baldy Brothers, Century FM.
Mike the Mouth with Blue Line Taxis. Order a BLT now. The icon has landed. He's Mike the Mouth Elliott, and you can call him now. 0191 477 2000.
Hello and welcome back to the show. Lovely to have you all here. I love every one of you, you know that. And therefore, I'm going to pick on Malcolm to talk to first. Thank you. Malcolm, how are you?
I'm not too bad, Mike.
Good lad, good lad. And since the 24 hours since we last spoke, what has been happening to your life?
Oh, I've just had a quiet day, Mike, you know, just in the yard, sitting in the deck chair, enjoying the sun. And
sun it was, to be enjoyed.
Eating a bit Turkish delight and having a few beers, Mike.
Oh, Turkish delight and a few beers, what more could a man want? You're like a sultan of Baghdad.
You're on about masturbation, Mike.
Yes, I am.
I think it depends where a person does it.
I don't think
it's right if they're doing it where, if people are doing it in public where there's little kids.
Well, no, I didn't mean where there's children. Like I wasn't talking about that. I'm talking about the workplace or maybe in a pub or maybe, you know, generally, where there's no children. I mean, I think that's perverse, but obviously I think where there's no children, yeah, where there's adults, maybe at work or somewhere like that. Have you seen anybody do it?
Not really, Mike, but how old are you,
Malcolm?
I'm 42, Mike.
And you've never seen anybody masturbate?
Why, I've been doing it for 30 years, Mike, I must confess.
You're 42, 12 years, yes. Well, some people start younger, but obviously has anybody caught you doing it?
Not really, Mike, no.
No,
no. So it's time and place, you can either do it in your own home, in the bathroom, in the toilet, or...
Why should you? Why should we hide? Uh-huh. Why? I mean, see, it's a normal, everyday act. We all do it, we all continue to do it. Even the Pope of Rome has done it sometime in his life. So there's no shame. Mother Teresa probably did it when she was a young girl.
Yeah.
You know, and the whole point is, why should we... Why? It's not a toilet thing, it's not a bathroom thing, it's not a sinful thing, it's not a disgusting thing, it's a very normal function. We've got it. It's if you believe in God, God give you the ability to masturbate.
Uh-huh.
So why hide it away? I'm not saying that we, you know, you should do it, you know, willy-nilly. Yeah. But I would rather see people coming out of a pub and masturbate rather than fight.
Yeah, with me it's more a hobby, Mike.
It's more a hobby?
Because some lot of people like train spotting and stuff like that. Why?
Well, I think you're using the wrong word when you talk about train spotting, actually. But I can understand where you're coming from. And the point is that, you see what I'm saying, is that we run away from it.
Uh-huh.
And yet, we should, you know, we do worse things in our lives. We fight, we brutalize,
uh-huh,
we kick people's heads in, we knife people, we stab, we hit them with bottles, and shoot them. And yet all these can be seen on the television. Mm. But somebody just slowly just jerking off is suddenly, you can't see that on television. No. Now, I think that is a very passive, peaceful, very loving sort of self-love. And why do we run away from it?
Yeah, well, that's what gets me, Mike, because they show sex films on the television, couples making love and that, but they never hardly show anybody, like...
Well, they do. In the porn films, the man does it, and just and they're having rumpy-pumpy, and just before he climaxes, he pulls out and sprays it all over the place,
uh-huh,
which is the most unnatural thing. I don't know any man who does this on a regular basis.
I can't
believe
they
would do that. But it's so natural. We're making a travesty of it.
Uh-huh.
But really, what we've done is we've shoved a very natural self-loving act into the dirty business, and yet we've promoted the nasty acts of murder and violence into the entertainment business.
I say, as long as it doesn't hurt anybody, that's right, you know.
It's in the eye.
Yeah.
But generally, no. Masturbation has never killed anybody, and it's never started a war.
Oh, no, that's true, Mike.
You know what I mean? It may well have finished a war, I don't know, but it certainly hasn't started a war. And I think I can't understand why we get upset. Now, there must be some people out there who've gone, oh, my God, what am I looking at? What am I seeing? And when they should be going, okay, fair do. That's your business. It's not bothering me.
A second point I'm making, Mike, is going on from masturbation is a lot of... A lot of religious groups frown on it, you know, Mike.
Well, I hate anybody frowning when I'm masturbating. I hate that. I can't stand a frown when I masturbate. I just say, I'm sorry, stop that.
And you know what, Mike? It's like what you see, everybody does it, even vicars.
When I was brought up a Catholic boy, I was told by teachers and priests that to masturbate, it was a mortal sin.
Uh-huh.
A mortal sin. So you're laying this on a boy coming up to puberty. You know, acne breaking out all hour, and suddenly, you know, you're worried, your voice is dropping, Adam's apples grown, hair sprouting God knows where, and testicles gone badoing, 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 and a penis that keeps getting erect, and you're thinking, what, and you're trying to push it down, wet dreams and everything else, wondering where it is, and I suddenly get this wonderful feeling of pleasure, of masturbation, and the bloody priest says, it's a mortal sin, I'm going to hell.
Mm-hmm.
And you think, what sort of God have I got?
Yeah.
What sort of God's up there? He gives us a willy that gets erect and gives me pleasure. And as soon as I enjoy the pleasure that he's given us, he's going to bang us down with the devil.
I don't think it's much good. I think it's the crap that's taught in chapel or churches.
Well,
it's
madness.
You know?
It's not a mortal sin, and it shouldn't be a mortal sin. And I was told it would make you blind. Well, I wear glasses.
Well, I wear glasses, Mike.
I've seen the Pope with glasses.
Yeah.
I've seen the Queen with glasses.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean? So I didn't buy that, but I think it's terrible that these people tell children that masturbation is wrong. Masturbation, if any kids listen, masturbation is not wrong. It's perfectly natural and nothing to be ashamed about.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Yeah, the final point about Ronnie Biggs, Mike.
Aye.
Yeah, I think you're perfectly right what you said. That the son should pay for him, you know.
Well, that was Dave from last night's idea, and I've got to concur. I concur with Dave.
Yeah, I back Dave up as well, mate. I agree entirely with Dave.
Champion Markham, you've got to go, because I've got to go as well. Excuse me, that's my business. If you don't mind. Thank you very much.
Call Mike the Mouth now. 0191-477-2000.
Yes, indeed, that's the number. We're going to the news, 11 o'clock news. See what's happening, maybe more about Biggsy. 0191-477-2000, see ya.
Get it on, I'm the man.
What's going on here?
Oh, stop, I didn't even hear it.
Making the Northeast laugh on the way home. The Baldy Brothers. Century FM.
If it wasn't for the name, you'd hardly recognise the place. Because Shaw Garden Centre has had a serious makeover. It's bigger, with trees, shrubs, conservatory furniture and garden accessories. It's better, with an extensive range of giftware, stylish stone ornaments, terracotta pots and paving. It's beautiful, with tropical fish, aquatic centre, interflora florist and a stunning new coffee shop for delicious hot and cold snacks. But best of all, Shaw Garden Centre still offer fantastic value for money. So why not put the new look Shaw Garden Centre at the top of your shopping list this bank holiday weekend? Shaw Garden Centre, Station Road, Cramlington. Shaw, it's the one you're looking for.
The Nopalist Air of one of the Northeast's most intrepid explorers, Miss Milburn. Miss Milburn wished to explore the outer reaches of her neighborhood. She visited New York, stopped off on Broadway, had lunch at the Hilton Cafe, and was home Washington by nightfall. And it only cost £3.70, and she never left Tynan Weir, because Miss Milburn bought a day rover ticket from Network Ticketing, offering a day's unlimited travel on the bus, metro, Newcastle to Sunderland train, and the Shields Ferry throughout Tynan Weir. Tickets available from most metro ticket machines, drivers of most buses, and network ticketing agencies. Where could your day rover ticket take you for only £3.70?
At Budget Windows, we build our replacement windows to last, because that's how we've built our reputation. With Budget Windows, you can have six windows from just £776, including VAT and fully fitted. Safe in the knowledge that your new windows come from a company that's never gone bust, never ceased trading, and never come back under another name. Six windows from £776. Call free on 0800-449-449 or visit the show site at North Tees Industrial Estate, Stockton, and make the right choice. Budget Windows.
Clients contact us when they have to sell their window endowment policy.
I would say our clients trust us, that's why Robin Lloyd has been in business successfully for over 27 years.
When you make the initial inquiry with us, there is no obligation at all, you're not committed to anything.
We get a valuation on the policy between 3 and 5 working days.
We can get up to 30%
surrender
value for them.
Our customers are always giving us feedback and telling us what good job we're doing for them.
A policy needs to be over six years old to be with the policy and have a surrender value of £2,000.
We have a website.
The address is robinlloydassociates.co.uk.
Robin Lloyd Associates is regulated by the Personal Investment Authority.
Have you heard Coffee in the Morning? Get your mates wound before they get you. 0191-475-760. Email coffee@centuryfm.co.uk.
And get ready to get wound up. Coffee in the morning. Century FM.
Who's done the coffee with the coffee wind up?
to serve the Northeast. This is Century FM.
It's 11 o'clock, I'm Louise Mitchell. Ronnie Biggs is back behind bars in Britain and planning to appeal against the 28 years left on his sentence for the Great Train Robbery. The frail 71-year-old was arrested after flying in from Brazil this morning. The Press Complaints Commission is to investigate Biggs' return, which came courtesy of The Sun. The Code of Conduct says payments can be made to criminals only if there's a public interest. But former Guardian editor and member of the PCC, Peter Preston, doesn't see there's a problem.
With the donation to Biggs or his relatives of this cash, he's home and in clink. Jack Straw is supposedly smiling. Justice has been done. Isn't that the public interest, they'll say.
A university student who was rushed to hospital after taking high-strength ecstasy has died. 19-year-old Lorna Spinks collapsed at a Cambridge nightclub in the early hours of yesterday morning. A police spokesman's confirmed she died at Addenbrooke's hospital early this afternoon with her parents at her bedside. Two 19-year-old men have been arrested in connection with supplying controlled drugs. The countdown's on to a general election after a special bank holiday cabinet meeting at Downing Street. Ministers have been approving the final version of Labour's manifesto and fine-tuning the campaign strategy. Tony Blair's expected to call an election for June the 7th in the next day or two. In snooker, Ronnie O'Sullivan has won his first Embassy World Championship title. He beat former champion John Higgins by 18 frames to 14. The 25-year-old world number 4 racked up a series of big breaks to claim the £250 winner's cheque. In football, Manchester City have been relegated after losing 2-1 to Ipswich Town at Portman Road. Joe Royle's men took the lead through Sean Gota before goals from Ipswich skipper Matt Holland and Dutch striker Martin Reusser left City with no way back. Club captain Steve Howie admits it was his team's inability to defend the cost them Premiership status.
We've played sort of well, and then we've let in some tough goals, and you know, you go 1-0 up and it's something to hang on to. But you know, the reason that we have been relegated is because we've conceded 2 goals, and that's the way it goes.
Independent Radio News.
Century FM weather with Auto Windscreens. Getting straight to the point, rain or shine.
Hello, you'd like some weather? I have lots of it, but it's generally wonderful. It's wonderful, wonderful, wonderful weather. Tonight, well, it's going to be dry and generally clear, but there will, you know, that might lead to a cold. It will be, actually, it will. The overnight temperature will be anywhere between 1 and 5 degrees centigrade. That's 32 to about 37, 38 degrees Fahrenheit. Obviously, colder on the coast and colder on exposed areas, especially high ground. That's your 1 degrees, 5 degrees more inland. That's overnight. Not too bad for overnight at this time of the year. Light northeasterly winds. Now, tomorrow, long sunny spells. Mist and cloud at the start, of course. Light variable winds. Now, the top temperature tomorrow, anywhere between 10 and 15 degrees. That 5 degrees spread again. Colder on the coast and on high ground and in exposed areas where there will be a wind with a variable winds. But generally, around about the 15 degrees, 59, 60 degrees centigrade. Very, very nice day. So enjoy it, even if you're going to work. And that, of course, where you're going to work, Gateshead and Century FM.
The icon has landed. He's Mike the Mouth Elliott, and you can call him now. 0191 477 2000. The icon has landed. He's Mike the Mouth Elliott, and you can call him now. 0191 477 2000.
You see, some of you weren't listening there, and I'm on to you. I'm on to you. Forget what we were talking about before the news. I don't care what you're doing, but listen to the show. We're going to talk to everybody who wants to pick up the phone and give us a bell. It is a free call. I mean, see, it'll cost you peanuts. We'll call you back. Little Lord Ned was there to take you onto a transport of delight. That's what Century's all about with Mike the Mouth. Lovely. So just pick up the phone, give us a bell, 0191-477-2000. And it was an interesting thing that little Ned spotted. These adverts, you know, I said, well, what paper is this? Oh, it's the Sport. and there's an advert here, a sizzling daily sport offer for every reader. Free, it shouts out. Free, it leaps out of the page at you. Free. Join the secret sex club and get £1 million worth of free sex gifts every week. £1 million every week? God almighty! I mean, they say you'd be red raw. God, dear you me, what are they offering? Just a fiver would do anybody normal. Mel.
Hiya.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry, I thought it was a woman. Hello, Mel, how's it going? Have a fanfare. Where are you from, Mel?
Do I get another one for a Century Virgin?
A Century Virgin called Mel. Let me think. That's a joy. So, Mel, my boy, where are you from?
Washington.
Oh, Washington. Yes, by Jove. Oh, goodness me. Dallas on the way. So, what can we do for you, Washington?
It was just about a story that somebody at Callers was talking about earlier about not being able to use a toilet in a store.
In stores, yes. It was a garden centre he'd been caught in. He had prostate trouble, so...
I was in a local electrical store in Gateshead where I was with my mother, and she wanted to use a toilet, and they didn't have any toilets for the public. So I asked if she could use a staff toilet, and they said no because of insurance reasons.
Bullshit. It's total bull. It really is bull. The idea that somebody going to the toilet is going to have... No, it's just total tosses. They are just... They're just silly, stupid shop assistants who really feel superior because we can have a pee and you can't. Ah, hearty, hearty. There's no excuse. It doesn't affect insurance whatsoever. Somebody going into a toilet and having a pee, if they have an accident, what sort of accident are they going to have? If there's anything that can cause an accident, then the shop should have it cleared up, because the same accident could happen to the staff, in which case they suffer potential legal action. So, no, it's not true. A good shop will build the system and services for the customers. A bad shop will deny them all access. And I'm simple and straightforward. If I go into a shop and I need to use the toilet and they won't allow me to use... the staff one, then they do not get my custom, and I tell everybody else not to use that shop.
Well, and let's boycott. I'll probably remember that the next time, because unfortunately I still bought something in that store this time.
Well, I wouldn't have. I would say if my mother's not good enough to sit in your lav, then my money's not good enough to sit in your till.
Uh-huh.
Simple and straightforward.
Because I accepted the answer that he gave me about insurance reasons. You know,
it's bull. Your mother goes into the toilet and she slips. Why did she slip? Is there something in there that makes her slip?
I suppose it might have been worried if she went in the toilet and come out like with a mask over her head.
Well, the same thing is when soon as she walks through the shop.
It's a good do exactly the same, yeah.
As soon as she walks into that shop, they shouldn't let customers in the shop. Yeah. Because the customer might have an accident. So that it's balderdash, and it's basically most stores, good stores. I mean, you go to Fenix, there's toilets. Big supermarkets should have toilets. If they haven't got toilets,
then... Well, this is a new store, though. Hey? It's a fair size.
Well,
it's a fair size.
There's no excuse. They should build toilets. I believe it should be law that all shops should have toilets. Well, they must have toilets and washing facilities for the staff, and they should be available to customers. They can be supervised, whatever, but they must be available. And over a certain size, they must also have a proper toilet. They've got to.
Well, anyway, what she ended up doing was having to walk a couple of hundred yards to a local takeaway and using their toilet facilities that were open to the public, and then come out without spending a penny in the shop.
Well, that's a service, you know, that you'll remember that place, and next time you're in, you might want to snag, you'll use them.
Yeah.
That's the bonus, you know, you've got to use your power of your money to smack these shops. If a bad shop, anything with bad service, you know, when you've got a supermarket with stupid women or on the checkout who just ignore you or fanny around or talk to the mates, you never go there again. They'll lose your custom. Eventually, it may well be that these women get the sack. Why? Because they haven't made the money. Why? Because it's their own bloody fault. So
Have you ever been in a public bar where there's been a sign that said these toilets are for customers only?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, well, and I can understand that. I can understand that the it's a public bar. Yeah. You go in, but I don't think it costs you anything. If you're going to go into a public bar and use their toilets, it costs you now to go and say, can I have a Diet Coke? Can I have a tonic water? I'll just be in the toilet and I'll come out, you know, and you can have a drink as well. I don't see any problem with that.
I often use it as an excuse to get a drink.
But most people, when they're in the shop, they haven't gone in the shop to have a piddle. They've gone in the shop to buy something.
Yeah.
And it's come on, and therefore the shop should help them. And
especially,
bottom line is, if they won't let you pay, just walk out and say, I'm taking my piddle and my money elsewhere.
Yeah. Just another point on the masturbation side. When I was at school, not long ago, there was a story going round that one of the lads had been caught masturbating in his living room. Apparently, he'd been watching this porn film, with headphones on, plugged into the television.
Mm-hmm.
And he was given a chip, and his parents walked in the middle of it.
Bless.
From what I gather, I don't know what his parents had said, but he now got the mickey taken out of him at school.
Well, his parents said, well, if his parents had gone out and tell everybody, then they should be ashamed of themselves.
No, I think he told one of his mates that his parents had called him, and this is what he was doing, and then it just got tilly-tottled around the school and that,
a parent should just... if I was a parent and I walked in on my child masturbating, and they spotted me, and I spotted them, I would say, I'm sorry. And I would just leave. And you enjoy yourself. I would leave. I certainly wouldn't go up the wall. That's what a parent should do. It's like anybody. It's an adult. Even if it's a teenager. You just say, oh, I'm sorry. Enjoy yourself. I'm going into the kitchen. That's what
you do. It's just relieving yourself in a way, isn't it? Because it's like going to the toilet for a pee.
I don't believe masturbation is anything about relief. I think it's about sheer pleasure. And,
well,
see, going to the toilet for a pee is not a pleasure. There are certain circumstances when it is a pleasure. But generally, it is just, getting rid of waste. But I don't think masturbation is getting rid of waste. I think it is a pleasurable experience and can fulfill you in so many ways that even possibly your partner can't. Even married people should masturbate. There's no problem with that. And married people should masturbate in front of each other. There should be no problem with that neither.
No.
You shouldn't be embarrassed by this. But the point is, what you shouldn't be is ashamed.
Well, I'm sorry, Mike, I'm going to have to go.
Go and have a wank. 0191-477-2000. Why not? Why not, indeed? Richard.
Hello, Mike.
Hello.
How's it going?
I'm okay, Richard. How are you?
Sounds like a wank to him, like, doesn't he?
No, he didn't. You would do. But carry on.
I wait, no.
What have you come on for?
I want to talk about bugs, actually.
You want to talk about bugs?
Bugs or toilets.
Are you talking about bugs in this century or this time zone or possibly other time zones?
Think of a famous toilet in South Shields.
That's the West Ornetti. Bob Ollie's painted it.
Yeah. Well, can you remember what the West Ornetti, the picture was?
I've got it. And not only that, but I piddled in the netty.
Have you got a photographic memory, Mike?
Have I got a photographic memory?
Close your eyes, and I bet you anything you like, you can remember the little lad pissing up against the bloke's leg.
It's happened, yes. We all can. That's one of the great little tricks of it.
Everybody's got a photographic memory.
You weren't the little lad, were you?
No.
Because I know Bob's one of my best mates, so I know that there was no role model for that. It was just a way of Bob's wonderful imagination. And I've got a signed print, limited edition, of the West Ornetti.
Well, Bob's me...
Not your uncle. Don't say Bob's your uncle. Because I'm going to smack you.
Sort of.
Is he? I must tell him to change his family.
Is like related directly to me, Mum.
All right.
So,
it's just too small a world,
isn't it?
It's just too small.
So anyway, I wanted to talk about like famous toilets, right?
Famous toilets, well, I mean, you say that one is one of the famous ones, West Stonehetty. The one at Big Market, the Victorian one, a wonderful example of Victorian toilet architecture. A joy to relax in and pee in.
Yeah. One that I wanted to mention, right, there's a little one at the back of South Shields, just off, do you know when you come out of the metro?
Yeah.
It used to be all brass. Lovely.
Beautiful. Polished.
Yeah, you could have a
little person.
Squite. There was one in the Market Square.
They're all gone now.
Yeah.
They're all gone, the toilets.
It's terrible, isn't it?
It's a scandal.
I used to enjoy.
Give me a proper marble tiled brass.
Yeah.
Wonderful, wonderful toilet with style and character, and a little man, or if you're a woman, a little woman cleaning it all out. And there was style, there was dignity, there was the pleasure of relieving yourself. And well, that one at Big Market is still one of the best one. He's gone now, of course.
Is that the Big Market like
in Newcastle? There's only one Big Market
where it's got the green. It's all green. And you go down the steps.
Yes, you go down the steps.
That's right. Yeah. It's lovely.
That's one of the great ones. That's one of the great ones. But most of them have gone now. You could walk in and walk out the other side, like the West Stonehetty, and they're all gone now, because we've lost part of our heritage.
Heritage, aye.
And public toilets are not what they used to be.
Beamish have got a canny one, like.
Aye, well, it's a long way to go for a was.
Know what I was thinking about, mate, right? Do you not think if we could all vote, right, to get all these re-established?
Well, I tell you where there's one, you know. Let's see. You know the Newcastle Central's Fire Brigade?
Well, that's a bit far for me from South Shields.
Well, Newcastle, if you come to Newcastle and you stand right outside the Newcastle Central Fire Brigade.
Right.
And you look across the road. On the left-hand side, there's a road goes down. It's the side of where the Theatre Royal is.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, right there, under there, is a beautiful Victorian toilet. That's being covered up. I think anybody in Newcastle will remember it. A wonderful, wonderful toilet, and that's been covered up, and it's been covered up for about 20 years. And they should reopen that very quickly as well, because it is I bet that everything is still there.
Because you keep saying, do you know, like, you used to go for an 11:40 dosh, didn't you? And Thomas Aycrop, our Bill used to come on and you see Thomas Aycrop and son sponsors Meg Elliott. What it is, right? I wonder if you could get there, this brass all polished up in your toilet. I was always fancying something like that.
What, and for your toilet?
Aye.
Well, it's a wonderful thought, and keep and hold that thought, Richard Champion. I'm not going to go down the path. I am not going to go down the path of digging toilets up so we can supply Richard with a brass lavvy. I refuse, and I think I'm doing you all a favour. Trust me on this one.
Call Mike the Mouth now. 0191 477 2000. Have a little fun in the office.
G'day, Steve Irwin here, wildlife reporter. And today, I'm searching for one of the most aggressive animals known to man. Drunken bloke, to close your time. Whoa, look, there's one.
You looking at you,
Mark Thorburn and the Comedy Boys, 10 till 2. Exclusive to Century FM, your official workstation. Your official workstation.
Right. If you have an accident and then make a claim,
24 inches
some
in
claims
diameter,
companies will take a percentage of your damages. But at AccidentClaimsNorth.com, what you win is what you get, which means whether we win or lose, you don't pay us a penny. Plus, we only appoint qualified local solicitors that come to you. And claiming for compensation doesn't necessarily mean you need to go to court. So for a professional service that won't cost you a penny, call AccidentClaimsNorth.com on 0800-855-855 or visit us at our website, AccidentClaimsNorth.com, taking your business but not your
on your license or even a bag. Now try saying cheese.
Get the message, not the picture.
Really? Enjoy your
at home.
home interior is
one of the northeast men's intrepid explorers, Miss Milburn. Miss Milburn wished to explore the outer reaches of her neighborhood. She visited New York, stopped off on Broadway, had lunch at the Hilton Cafe, and was home in Washington by nightfall. And it only cost £3.70, and she never left Tyne and Wear because Miss Milburn bought a day rover ticket from Network Ticketing, offering a day's unlimited travel on the bus, metro, Newcastle to Sunderland train, and the Shields Ferry throughout Tyne and Wear. Tickets available from most metro ticket machines, drivers of most buses, and Network Ticketing agencies. Where could your day rover ticket take you for only £3.70?
Direct from London's
Budget Windows, a new 3x3-metre Victorian-style conservatory is now from only £3,800 fully fitted and built to last. And because Budget Windows have never gone bust, disappeared, or come back under another name, it's reassuring to know you're being looked after by a company that lasts. The only thing that can't last long is our lowest price ever on Victorian-style conservatories from just £3,800. Call free on 0800-449-449 or visit the show site at North Tees Industrial Estate, Stockton, and make the right choice. Budget Windows.
Dave.
I went with Albert to the surgery today. The nurse there said that he was in amazing condition for his age. She winked at him. I bet you still know how to have a good time, you old rogue. He certainly does. He sniffed just about every lamppost we passed on the way home. Like Albert, with IAMS, your dog can also stay healthy and active. That's because IAMS Senior is the dog food scientifically proven to take the immune system of an 8-year-old dog back to the level of a much younger adult. IAMS. Welcome to a new world of health.
I went with Albert to the surgery today.
Don't you think it's time we got a place to get
an amazing condition for his
first, I need a job with more money.
Well, what about Total Jobs? They've got thousands of jobs. I'm interviewing.
Let me stop you there, my love. You do know that Total Jobs backwards means I give myself to the Dark Lord. And we don't want to be messing with the Dark Lord,
your dog can also stay healthy and active. Not the Dark Lord.
Over 50,000 jobs online, Total Jobs works wonders. So long as you wanted to.
TotalJobs.com.
Don't be a victim. Get your mates wound up before they get you wound up. Got this wound up. Gothy's wind up. Get ready to get wound up. Mike the Mouth with Blue Line Taxis. Order a BLT now. The icon has landed. He's Mike the Mouth Elliott, and you can call him now. 0191 477 2000.
Hey, as you would. I mean, you see. Yeah. One thing I was noticed this weekend, how many people are playing golf? What a stupid game. You know, it just seems to me the most ridiculous game. And these people get in the most ridiculous posture, sticking their bums out and waggling them, and the chins and the arms and the shoulders. They're a totally deformed position to hit this stupid little ball. I mean, is it the most ridiculous game in the world, golf? Can you think of a more ridiculous game than golf? Please fall in and tell me. You know, they're just boring. People who play golf, boring. You know, talking about birdies, eagles, and pars. Who cares? It's a little hole. Why not make the hole bigger? You know, if you're that desperate to knock the ball in, make the hole bigger, for God's sake. Make a bigger club or something, or bigger ball. I don't care. I just think they're boring. Hey, golf just drives him up the wall. Anyway, we've been mentioning, you know, Wembley, what it should be built up here. All the MPs up here have now jumped on the icon's bandwagon. Chris Evans has got married in Las Vegas to Billy Piper. There you go. Is that cradle snatching? I don't know. Well, there's nothing wrong with marrying an older man, you know, more wisdom. I'm talking about me. I'm talking about me. I'm not talking about Chris Evans, you know, the ginger minge. But there you go, he's married. We've got the, what else? Oil companies, are you going to boycott Esso? Are you going to join this boycott? Do you think they should be nationalised? Have you ever caught anybody or seen anybody masturbating? Are you shocked by me using the word? Is it upset you? Why? And has religion cost you a relationship or a friendship even? So give us a bell on that as well. Oi, oi, tiddly, oi, tie, rum on bricks. Patrick, there he is, there he is, and there he is. Hello.
Hello, mate, how are
Hello,
you?
Hello, Patrick, me darling.
I'm as fit as a flea and twice as lively.
Oh, be dear, be dar, be dody.
Aye, be worried. Right then.
So how's life, what, well, we're not life treating you, but what you been doing now with this lovely bang on the weekend?
I've been taking it easy, I've been making my kids a trolley cart.
Oh, that's nice. That's good. Making something for the bands to play on. That's wonderful.
Aye.
Aye. That's the way Dad should be.
I was, I got one of the Welsh magazines. You probably see some murder mystery things, you know?
Oh.
And I'm looking at it here. You know the Bamber that killed his family?
Aye, Bamber. He's fighting an appeal. He's got an appeal coming up.
He has
new evidence or something.
From what I'm looking at here and after reading about him, he's got a point. I think he was framed.
Well, who by, do you think?
It's like I can say, so he couldn't gain entry to the house, because all the windows and doors were securely locked. How could he be the murderer? Because he couldn't get into the actual house.
Well, he's the son, so he must have had a key.
I tell you, like this, the police, the forensic science, they put up no DNA or anything like that. Had they brought up DNA, it would have been odd on that he'd got out.
He tried to blame his sister, didn't he? Or something like that.
It was queer, Mike. It was a queer sort of a trial. I believe myself, the police like to be under terrible pressure to arrest somebody.
Well, they always are. But the police, just because the press are jumping down the throat, what the police have got to do, and sadly they fail miserably so many times, is not to react to the papers, is to ignore the papers. In fact, you know, once the papers start jumping, the papers should be forced further out. Because, you know, everybody's innocent until proven guilty. That's for starters.
I'll give you the bottom line of what he says here. He says, no forensic evidence, no scenes of crime evidence, no witnesses of evidence, and no confession.
Well, obviously there's no witnesses, because the murderer was in there with these people and that was it. The only witness is the killer, so that's not going to be held. Obviously the victims can't talk about it because they're dead. So that wipes that out. He had barristers. Anyway, it's going to appeal. It's obviously there's something smelly that's forced it through to an appeal situation.
Because the thing, if he murdered his parents, like the people, he couldn't gain anything from insurances or anything like that.
Well, he would if he wasn't found guilty of murder.
Well, that's what I'm saying. If you're found guilty, you'll be found guilty of murder.
Well, yeah, but when you commit a murder, Patrick, do it with the intention of not being caught. There's this arrogance that you'll get away with it. And whoever killed, let's say it was him, then he's done it in the hope that he'll have covered his tracks to such an extent and put red herrings all over the place that he would be investigated, because anybody with a brain knows that the first person's to be investigated in a murder inquiry are the people's closest to the victims. So he would have covered himself and hoped that he would be exonerated and be free then to inherit all the wealth and spend it laldy-faldy. Now, if he's guilty, then he's ballsed up, as most murderers do. If he's not guilty, then he's an innocent man jailed, and there is still a murderer out there. And if he is not guilty, and he's proved not guilty, then he will inherit the money.
And what I've looked at here now, this thing, I give him the benefit of the doubt.
Well, I understand. I've never read. I know this for a fact from the case of Sue Mayer, who was in Durham Jail. I read all her case notes and trial notes, and I believe she was guilty of murder. I believe she was innocent. She was found guilty of murder, I mean, and sentenced to jail sentence. I believe that she didn't kill. I've read everything. And I don't believe, I think there's an innocent woman in jail. I know that can happen.
I know, with this fella now looking at us, with a second chance, he would have known, like everybody that has a half brain in their head, knows that if you kill the person that you're waiting to inherit his farm, you weren't going to get nothing. It was the next person on that they get it.
No, well, of course you would expect, if I killed my mother, I'd be the first person to be investigated. I'd be thoroughly investigated, especially if there was the inheritance angle. That's the way the police work. Police work in a murder, with the closest family members and slowly work out. And they also throw out a thing and work in. And they're looking, and the odds are, 9 times out of 10, six times out of 10, or 7 times out of 10, it is a close personal family member or a friend who's done the deed. For whatever reason.
He was after being in Australia twice,
But what does that mean, Patrick? You shouldn't be anywhere near a bloody jury.
That he was having a fairly good life,
the fairly good life would cost money. And he's got two old people here who are fanning around and refusing to die, and he knows if they die, he's going to have a better life and a longer better life. That's good enough reason to kill people.
It's a motive, if there's no doubt about it.
Oh, Patrick, honestly, you are naive. I don't know whether the guy's guilty or not. He was found guilty in a court. All the evidence, I believe, that was produced, and a jury found him guilty. Now he's got leave to appeal. I don't know why. But I still would say, on the evidence that I read through the papers, he was guilty as hell.
Well, that's not the way it's coming across here.
Somebody's wrote it with one bias.
Yeah.
Go ahead. It's not written. It's written with a bias to toss an opinion up. Doesn't mean that what you've read is the truth.
Is the actual truth of it all.
Doesn't.
But we expect to see this brought out in the light and gone through again.
That will happen in an appeal. He will have a legal representative, the Crown will have a legal representative, and it will be argued, and if new evidence is there, that will be produced. If there's an argument that the police did not provide the right evidence at the right time, or the withheld evidence, that's another argument. If they believe that the judge in his running of the case and his summing up was biased, that's another. We don't know which way it's going to go, but it will go, and he will get a fair hearing. But you'd let him off, and I'd put him in the oven. Champion. 0191 477 2000. Gulp, 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 gulp. Oh, now Julie, the month I was born. it's a favourite name of mine, Julie. If I was a girl, I'd be called Julie. I would. What would you be called if you were a lad, Bert?
No, I don't know. Never thought of it.
You never wanted to be a boy?
No, not really.
Never. Well, there must have been times.
No, I quite like being a girl.
Oh, and being a woman. I'm a woman. W-O-M-A-N. So where are you from, Julie? Have a fanfare.
Thank you. I'm from Washington.
Oh, aye. And how is Washington?
Oh, fine. Being nice and sunny like most of the places.
Lovely day. Yeah. I'm telling you that now.
What I'd like to talk about is absent fathers.
Aye.
Right? I've got two beautiful children, and the dad doesn't want to know. And I was wondering if any of the men out there could give some, feedback on why this would be so.
Right, how old's the bands?
12 and 13.
12 and 13, and what's their first names? Do you want to tell us? Don't tell us. Right. So the 12 and 13, and this is the birth father.
Mm-hmm.
And these names on the birth certificate, is it?
Mm-hmm.
And were you married or just partners?
We lived together for 14 years.
14 years, mm-hmm. And then he upped sticks.
So,
how many years ago?
About 4 years.
So for 10 years, he was, your partner and their dad, and he went out to work, did he?
No.
He didn't work?
Nope.
Why didn't he not work?
he wouldn't get up and work. He's one of these lazy people. And then if I tried to get many jobs, and I did get many jobs, but then he would get sick of watching the children, so I would have to pack these jobs.
I'm afraid you've grown up into a woman, mm-hmm. and he's still a boy. Mm-hmm. That's the first, and I'm amazed that women don't recognise this. Mm-hmm. That this is not. Don't ever call this man a man. Mm-hmm. He's a boy, uh-huh. right? He's a youth. He has not developed maturity. He may have a penis and he may have sperm. But 12-year-olds have that.
Yeah.
He's a boy. Uh-huh. He's a lazy bugger as well. Uh-huh. And why you stuck with him for all that years is beyond me, because you should have given him the bums rush very quickly.
Yeah.
He's a lazy, idle tosser. Mm-hmm. Who really deserves to be horsewhipped around Washington. No, that's the first thing.
Could I be holding the whip?
I would hold them down for you. Now, the kids have somehow got through their life having to put up with this person's mm-hmm. existence. And they're now moving into the teenage years. Do they miss him?
They don't say that much of him, but they get upset,
mm.
you know.
How on you want to sit down and, are the girls or boys?
Boys.
You want to sit down and really, for future, just for their life in the future, because they're going to have to grow up to be men.
Mm-hmm.
And I think you want to need, do you have a brother who's a man or somebody who's close that the kids can respect who is a man?
I've got a brother, but we don't see him that much. And so, like, my boys haven't, like, got a male role model, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? And
I mean,
I've begged the dad to come see them.
Don't beg this boy.
Let him go.
He's not worth a toss.
Yeah.
Really, he's not worth a toss. He's more trouble than he's worth.
Yeah.
Right, the only good thing he's done in his life and your life is that he's impregnated you twice and you've got two great kids.
Mm-hmm.
That's the sum nature. He wouldn't work. What a man would go out and work. A man would work to not only put a roof over the kids' heads and feed and clothe them, but also work to improve himself to get better conditions for his children. That's what a man would do. Mm-hmm. This tosser is selfish, little boy mentality. Selfish. Yeah. Boys are selfish. So, you know, you've survived him. He's gone out your life and let him stay out your life. Don't ever ask him again.
Mm-hmm.
And what you've got to do is talk to your children now and sit them down and start telling them what a man is. They're going to grow from boys to men.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to develop.
Yeah.
Right, but it's not the development, the physical development, it's the mental development.
Mm-hmm.
And you've got to tell them truthfully, your dad, right, was a sorry lot as a man. He didn't make it as a man.
Yeah,
right?
I have actually, like, sat down and tell them things and, like, I say to them, the way that a man behaves is not the way, and a father behaves is not the way that your father's behaving.
A father is there for his children and his wife.
Mm-hmm.
He is there even if he falls out of love with his wife, he's there. And he works. Once a child has come into this earth, he works.
Mm-hmm.
That's a man and a father. Anything he doesn't do that, he's not a man, and he certainly doesn't deserve the wonderful title of father. It's an honour to have the title father and dad bestowed on you by society, and more especially by your kids.
Mm-hmm.
And it's an honour to grow up from a boy to be a man,
mm-hmm.
and to act like a man and take responsibilities of a man. And many of these responsibilities are to look after a family, to look after a woman and their children. That's
mm-hmm.
hard. It means not taking the shortcut and stealing and going into crime. It means knuckling down and doing the hard, everyday, boring, mundane thing of keeping a home together. They're the heroes, not the criminals. So your kids need to know that you're basically, sadly, luckily they may have your genes, but they've got some of his in them, and what he's done is a total sorry. He's an abject failure as a father, and he's a total disaster because he still thinks he's a man, so he's a lie to himself. You need that explained to these boys so that when they grow through from boyhood into manhood, they hold on to this concept of what being a man is.
Mm-hmm.
Don't bother with this tosser. Ignore him. Get him out of your life. He's not worth a blink of an eye. Honestly.
Thank you.
You're more of a man than him. And you've certainly been a better father than him.
Yeah.
Be proud of yourself. Be proud of them lads. And just sit down and talk about what do you think? What is, ask them. What do you think? What is a man? What is a man? Now they might come up. Well, he shaves and he makes babies and he goes to work and he looks after. Does he look after his wife if she's well? He's got to look after his wife when she's pregnant, doesn't he? Because she can't maybe work all that right till the end. So he'll look after that. And when the baby comes, that's his. That's his as much as his wife's. That's his. He's got to look after that baby and make sure it's safe and protected and make sure it's got a roof and clothes and food. And then, that's not enough. He wants to do better. He wants the kid to be better than him and to have a better life than him. That's a man and that's a father. Develop it that way.
Yeah, you're but totally
keep,
right.
Keep the tosser out.
Yeah.
Give him the bum's rush. He's not worth a light.
Okay, then.
And best of luck. We're here any time.
Okay. Pardon?
We're here any time for you.
Okay, then. Right, thanks.
Go for it, Dad. 0191-407-2000. Sorry. But if you fit into the category of that man, then you're not a man. You're a boy. And you don't ever, ever, if you've left your child and walked out of it, don't ever use the name father. Because you are beyond contempt. You don't deserve it.
G-O-F-F-Y.
Born and bred in the northeast. Coffee in the morning. Weekdays from 20 past 6 and Sundays from 9. Coffee in the morning. Only on Century FM.
That brings the scores level.
Did you know? Recent research shows that, pound for pound, radio advertising can be up to 4 times more effective than TV advertising in generating awareness.
That makes Jim our winner. Thank you. Well done.
Something to think about, isn't it? Turn the TV off, Lenny. Cheers. Radio advertising. It's more powerful than it looks. For details, visit rab.co.uk.
Right. I just need a little space, that's all, just short term. What's called somewhere that's safe, secure and affordable.
Speed limit it's all right, I understand. We can provide you with a 10-foot storage container from just £15 per week.
Okay,
now, how does that sound?
Seen the
great. Whether you need
discs,
to store the contents of a whole house or just archive your office records, the Mobile Storage Group has the answer for you. Feel free to visit our new secure self-storage facility at Hope in the Spring, where we offer a quick and easy solution to your storage problem. With standard 20-foot containers costing just £20 per week, right at your 40-foot jumbo at £40 per week. We are the Container People, the temporary accommodation and storage specialists. Call the Mobile Storage Group now on 0191-584-1992. That's 584-1992.
Get the message.
The Mobile Storage Group. Storage solutions for the 21st century.
I had a dream
right,
that
so to celebrate the launch of the new Hyundai Elantra Selina, Durham Hyundai are selling a limited number at 9299.
Yes.
That's
that
a saving of over £1,600 with 3 years free servicing.
That's right.
Marriage? This is the worst
the
case of a Hyundai hallucination I've ever come across. Next
no,
week,
says
the new Hyundai Elantra Selina comes with aircon, electric windows, front and side airbags.
Yes, it does.
And you say there's only a limited number.
Yes.
Well, you stay there. It's all in your head. Helga, my
you could talk to anyone about the Hyundai immediately.
The new Hyundai Elantra Selina is at Durham Hyundai Main Road Garages, Framelgate Moor, Durham now for just 9299. But hurry, there's only a limited number.
Choose the Helga, use the beep. I do like it when you use the beep.
2575.
Hello?
We've had a bit of a delayed start to the flat racing season here at Newcastle Racecourse, but now they're off. Racing is back on at Newcastle. The first flat race of the season is May Day Bank Holiday at 2:25. The horses are champing at the bit. The jockeys are raring to go for a great family day out and loads for the kids. Start the season at Newcastle Racecourse.
Dewhurst Impressions have cleared several warehouses to make room for new summer stock, and they're selling these clearance lines with up to 75% off. 75% off Dewhurst's already low prices. So whatever you do this bank holiday weekend, make sure you visit your local Dewhurst Impressions factory shop at North Seaton Industrial Estate Ashington, opposite the Echo Sunderland, and Northwest Industrial Estate Peter Lee. With up to 75% off the original prices, all you need is a few bob and a truckload of space.
Don't be a victim.
I want my money and I want it now. I'll come through there with ya.
Mike the Mouth with Blue Line Taxis. Order a BLT now. The icon has landed. He's Mike the Mouth Elliott, and you can call him now. 0191-477-2000.
Indeed, a goodness indeed. I saw, I was telling them last night, I had a box of six eggs. Everyone was double yolk.
Very, very rare. I haven't seen a double yolker for ages.
Well, I've got to tell you that it's amazing. It's the most amazing thing is that six eggs and the whole box was double yorkers. I must be a Guinness Book of Records job.
Must be, aye. Free range.
Free, oh yeah. I never eat anything but free range. Mm. Won't have them. You know, I don't care if they say country, it's got to be free range. And these are the, well done Morrison's, I've got to say Morrison's, because I've got to say they were some of the best eggs I've never, six double yorkers.
That must be, but then again, you can't prove it now, can you?
No, no, I've eaten them.
That's right.
It's very difficult when
I
you...
I suppose you must have been quite excited when you...
Oh, exactly.
Yeah, exactly.
But don't good.
Your idea of a yolk.
Ah, wow, wow, wow.
I'm really shell-shocked, Mike. Your turn.
I've given up. No, I can't be bothered. Anyway, I thoroughly enjoyed it and...
Making me feel hungry.
Well, I had a wonderful dinner today. I took the Mem Sarban child out for a meal. Luciano's in Tynemouth. Luciano's. Beautiful. And I had the veal. I had veal just grilled with... Because I can't eat potatoes,
you see. Last time you were talking like this, at this time of night, people were ringing in complaining.
I know.
Lying in bed listening to the show.
I'm complaining.
They wanted to get up, go down and make themselves something to eat.
Well done, Leo, at Luciano's. The food was, as ever, superb. You can't, and the dessert.
Tonight, now, rather than go straight to bed, I'm going to have to make myself something to eat.
Yeah, I'll have to. But I start out with gamberoni. Beautiful, beautiful seafood. And garlic, and then I had the veal.
I don't like garlic. Ugh.
And it was just a super. So Leo, thank you. Well done, Luciano's. Great restaurant in Tynemouth.
Morrison's restaurant.
Well, I'm not planning to get anything up here, but I just think people should be told Morrison's. They call the very big free range eggs. And they're superb. Some of the best eggs I've tasted for a long while. There used to be a little guy in North Tyneside I used to buy me eggs off about 5-6 years ago, but vandals got in and wrecked the whole lot.
Great.
But his were superb eggs, and there was double yorkers there, but never six in a box.
I get mine from the same place.
Well,
market every Sunday morning.
Well, I get mine from the same place as you. This is the hen's arse. Well, not the hen's bottom, excuse me.
Joe's fishnet, that's what I think it's called.
Joe's fishnets, excuse me.
They go to all the different markets, and I tend to go to Sunday market where I live in.
Oh, well, I'm off a farm.
20 eggs for £2. £1.99, but I never get a penny change.
They're not free range.
No, not free range.
Oh, you should buy free range.
I can't afford it. You're on more money than me.
I know I'm on more money than you, but it's healthier, and it's better for the hens. You've got to think of the chucky ends. Anyway, I'm going to talk to Natalie, you know, because you callous brute, you don't care about hens' fadges.
I can't afford to buy, I love free-range eggs, but I can't afford to buy them.
I know, but I've always bought free-range, even when I was skint. I would always spend the money on free-range.
I do like them. Duck eggs, have you ever tried that?
Oh, duck eggs. You kind of get duck eggs. Geese eggs, have you tried a goose egg?
No, I haven't tried those.
Great.
You can get duck eggs from the market.
Oh, I know.
Again, Joe's fishnet.
I know. Joe's fishnet, right? Yeah. I haven't had a duck egg, but it'll have to be an organic. It'll have to be a free-range duck. Natalie, are you there?
Yeah.
Hello, darling. Welcome to the show. You're a bit faint. Where are you?
I'm in the house.
Oh, thank God. Now, keep there. For God's sake, don't leave the phone, otherwise I'll not know where you are. Have a fanfare, Natalie! Just a minute. I'm terribly sorry, but you will keep doing that with me. I'm terribly sorry, Natalie, but it's little Lord Ned playing with me nubs. So then, Natalie, how are you?
I'm fine.
Good. Good. And have you had a nice weekend?
Yeah.
Good. And what are you phoning me for?
About your worst embarrassing moment.
I'm sorry?
The most embarrassing moment.
Oh, what was that then?
Right, well, my mum was outside cleaning the windows.
Right, I'm just putting the guy. Can you speak over? Because I've. Can you get some more volume on that, Ned? Go on then. Your mum was outside cleaning the windows.
Yeah, and I was outside with her.
Right.
And my mum had farted.
I beg your pardon. Out of your mouth? Eh, bless her. Go on, yes.
And she jumped behind the van. And I was like, left just me on my own. And there was loads of like schoolgirls and boys walking past. And they just thought it was me, and they started laughing and everything.
Yes, you what a swine of a mother. To leave a big bairn to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune. So, your mum was on the ladders. Was she on ladders?
No, she wasn't on the ladders.
So she was down on the ground, and she was cleaning the window, and she suddenly let rip. And she immediately, did she jump, or did the force of the fart fly her behind the van?
She jumped.
And she deliberately left you to suffer the sniggers of these other... How old are you, like?
I'm 16.
16, and I bet you're absolutely gorgeous, Natalie. I bet you're a stunner, aren't you?
Yeah.
And there's no worse than a young girl, because nobody believes that young girls pump. I know that. You didn't know the pump, did you, Ned?
I had no idea,
no. You had no idea, but I knew. And so what did your mum say afterwards?
She was just laughing.
Funny, though, isn't it? It's one of the perks of being a parent. So you'll remember now, Natalie, that when if you get married, never Ben, or you have to get married these days, don't you? Then she's 17 or 16, and you know you can drop one and bugger off and let her tit, and you'll know what it's all about. You know, a bit of fun and frolics.
Yeah, but the only thing ever, I went to school the next day and I got really shown off.
Oh.
I was telling them it wasn't me, but they were saying, well, you're the only person that was there.
Because your mother was behind the van, sniggering. Yeah. And farting, probably. She was probably doing a lot. He's disgraceful. No, well, I'm so sorry. It's too late now to phone the NSPCs. I'd have her arrested myself. but who's going to make your beard up? That's the trouble. They've got some use as mothers, but... I like her style, actually, I've got to say. I do like it. I think one of the great joys of being a parent, I mean, because most of the time, all we're doing as parents is handing money to you and yelling at you. And if we can get you into the cack, it's great fun. It is great fun. It's one of the perks, you know. So how's life generally? I mean, did you have a boyfriend at school when this happened?
Yeah.
Is he still your boyfriend?
Yeah.
Oh, well, there you are, then. But mind, he hasn't gone kinky and said, Natalie, would you please pump on me foot? He hasn't done that, has he?
No.
No, so he's let it go. So there you are, you've still got your lad. So when are you getting married?
Well, not too much of the marriage yet.
I should damn well hope not. If you tell anything else, I'll come home and bloody... Ooh. What? So you don't get married till you're 32, pet?
Yeah, that's right.
Plenty of time. And that would really get you revenge on your mother. By saying, Mother, I love you that much, and because you farted and got me the blame, I'm going to stop with you till I'm 32. Oh, she'd gone up the wall. She'd gone berserk, I'll tell you. 32? I want rid of you by the time you're 21. So you can really wreak revenge there, I'll tell you.
My mum would probably want
it
out by
18. Oh, shit, no, mother's done it, man. But most mothers done it. They want to keep you there. If they could, they'd put you in a room and lock you up. Yeah. You know? And especially when you get 19 and 17, you know, kids, you know, you girls, you get really funny, you get witty, and it's good, get good fun. So mothers, they want to be your best mate, share your makeup, you know, share your frocks and tights and stuff like that. That's what women, my mothers are, man, they're daft.
I know what you are.
So what's your mother's first name?
Dawn.
Dawn, is she listening?
No, she's in bed at the moment.
Well, she's asleep, is she? So she doesn't know that you've come on and told me this story, does she?
No.
So she doesn't know that all our neighbours have heard this story, does she?
No.
So she doesn't know that all the street now know that she farts. So, Don, when you wake up tomorrow morning, you may well get a shock of your life, pet.
Yeah.
So
well,
you can.
I've just got her back.
You can tell her you've had revenge. Well, because now there's some like over 500,000 people know that you mother farts. Okay?
Yeah.
Anytime you want, Natalie, give us a bell. All the best.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye. Oh, embarrassing moments. Yeah, mine was when I had my first bra. '07, 2000 I know there's people to come, but we're going to the news. So we'll come to you after the news, if you'd bear with me for a while, like. And the number to ring, of course, as you all know, is...
Call Mike the Mouth now. 0191-477-2000.
You can't have gone wrong with that, can you? And I'll be here after the news, and little old Ned is taking calls. Yoo-hoo, Ned. Yes, he's there. So give us a bell, and let's come on and boogie. We've only got an hour, so let's not miss the opportunity. Okay, gang? Champion. He was a wonder horse, but it's also the name of this show. Well, I like to call it that.
The biggest names to wake up to 7 days a week. This is the new home of Tony Horn in the morning. Tony Horn in the morning. Weekend 6 to 9. Century FM.
At Lucas Volkswagen Teesside now.
Savings on a new bathroom suite from the bathroom studio just keep getting better. Because when you purchase a complete bathroom suite from selected ranges from the bathroom studio, you'll receive a superb matching bath absolutely free. The complete service, design and installation, and a huge choice of exclusive bathroom designs you simply won't find anywhere else. With a free bath, an exclusive traditional or contemporary bathroom becomes even more affordable from the bathroom studio.
Miss Milda wished to explore the outer reaches of her neighborhood. She visited New York, stopped off on Broadway, had lunch at the Hilton Cafe, and was home in Washington by nightfall. And it only cost £3.70, and she never left Tyne and Wear because Miss Milburn bought a day rover ticket from Network Ticketing, offering a day's unlimited travel on the bus, metro, Newcastle to Sunderland train and the Shields Ferry throughout Tyne and Wear. Tickets available from most metro ticket machines, drivers of most buses and Network Ticketing agencies. Where could your day rover ticket take you for only £3.70?
At Budget Windows, we build our replacement windows to last, because that's how we built our reputation. With Budget Windows, you can have six windows from just £776, including VAT and fully fitted. Safe in the knowledge that your new windows come from a company that's never gone bust, never ceased trading, and never come back under another name.
To change the look and feel of your room, you could use the ancient art of Pungi Shoe, which involves painting everything lime green, sawing the legs off the sofa.
Six windows from £776. Call free on 0800 449 449, or visit the show site at North Tees Industrial Estate, Stockton, and make the right choice.
Selection available. Clients contact us when they have decided to sell their with-profits endowment policy.
With a minimum of fuss.
I would say our clients trust us. That's why Robin Lloyd has been in business successfully for over 27 years.
When you make the initial inquiry with us, there is no obligation at all. You're not committed to anything. We get a valuation on a policy between 3 and 5 working days. We can get up to 30% more than the surrender value for them.
With budget windows, our customers are always giving us positive feedback and telling us what a good job we're doing for them.
A policy needs to be over 6 years old to be a with-profit endowment policy and have a surrender value over £2,000.
Cease trading and never come back under another name.
We have a website. The address is robinlloydassociates.co.uk.
Robin Lloyd Associates is regulated by the Personal Investment Authority.
Call free on 0800
Robin Lloyd are the endowment people.
Or visit the show site at North Tees Industrial Estate, Stockton, and make the right choice. Budget Windows. Have a little fun in the office.
Century FM, your official workstation.
What would you pay to drive what car's estate car of the year? What would you pay for outstanding style, performance and sheer practicality? Under £300 a month at Mill Volvo, the incredible V70 Torslander gives you saloon car comfort and refinement with estate car practicality. Outstanding luxury specification, including metallic paint, with real drivability to redefine what an estate car should be. And right now at Mill Volvo, driving one costs under £300 a month. Don't compromise. The Volvo V70 Torslander. What car estate car of the year is yours to drive away from under £300 a month at your local Mill Volvo. Test one today. Cash price £29.94. Deposit £5.925. 1 month at 384.61. 34 months at 299.61. 1 final month at 344.61. Final option to buy 7.393. Total credit price 242.33.96. APR 9.66. Ask for written details.
Proud to serve the Northeast. This is Century FM.
It's midnight. I'm Louise Mitchell. Great train robber Ronnie Biggs is back in jail after flying back to Britain from Brazil. The 71-year-old, frail from a series of strokes, was arrested immediately on arrival and taken to court. And Kevin Murphy was there.
He was a frail old man supporting himself on a walking stick. After a number of strokes, only able to grunt a response to questions and constantly wiping his mouth with a handkerchief. The magistrate ordered his return to prison, but outside the court, a statement on his behalf read by solicitor Jane Waring.
He will seek a hearing before the Court of Appeal in respect of his outstanding sentence.
Some bystanders said he should have stayed in Brazil instead of becoming a drain on the British taxpayer. But for now, he's back in Belmarsh Prison. Kevin Murphy, West London Magistrates Court.
Police have issued warnings to the public following the death of a university student who'd taken high-strength ecstasy. 19-year-old Lorna Spinks died in hospital after collapsing in a Cambridge nightclub. Two teenagers have been arrested in connection with the supply of controlled drugs. A 70-year-old woman's been shot after being caught up in a street ambush in Manchester. The victim, who's not been named, was rushed to hospital, where she's now in a stable condition. It happened in the Longsight area of the city. The countdown's on to the general election after a special bank holiday cabinet meeting at Downing Street. Ministers have been approving the final version of Labour's manifesto and fine-tuning the campaign strategy. Tony Blair's expected to call an election for June the 7th in the next day or two. And after today's meeting, Health Secretary Alan Milburn said they're ready for battle.
We'll fight this campaign whenever it comes, as if it were on a knife edge. That's the right thing to do. We're not going to take a single vote for granted. There are votes there to be won. And our strategy will be to fight a positive campaign.
In football, Manchester City have been relegated from the Premiership after being beaten 2-1 by Ipswich Town at Portman Road. Joe Royal's men took the lead through Sean Gota, but goals from Matt Holland and Martin Reusser condemned City to the drop. And in snooker, Ronnie O'Sullivan has won his first Embassy World Championship title. He beat former champion John Higgins by 18 frames to 14. Independent Radio News.
Century FM weather with auto windscreens. For a clearer outlook, get straight to the point.
Ha-ha! Straight to the point indeed. Well, here we are. Good morning to you, by the way. Good morning here after the bank holiday. It's Tuesday, the 8th, I believe. And the weather. I know you want the weather. Well, overnight, as you're listening to Vicky Archer say, and the wonderful Century FM programmes through the night, it's going to be a clear night, and that will lead to some low temperatures, 1 degrees and 5 degrees, around that area. There could be 0 degrees temperature on high ground and around the coastal areas, and possibly even some frost. But 5 degrees generally inland, and light northeast winds. Today was about 10% chance of fog here. Misty at the start of the morning, but generally long sunny spells. Temperatures, well, up to 15 degrees centigrade, 59 degrees Fahrenheit, thereabouts. Again, slightly cooler at the coast, and it generally is going to be a lovely, lovely day. Enjoy it, for goodness sake. Where there's no rain, go out and enjoy it, especially down at Saltburn-by-Sea and at Century FM.
Mike the Mouth with Blue Line Taxis. Order a BLT now. The icon has landed. He's Mike the Mouth Elliott, and you can call him now. 0191 477 2000.
Oh,
I'll do that, mate.
So you're off to the farms today,
eh? Yeah, just have a sail up.
That'd be lovely, huh? Yeah, I haven't been for a while.
I
want
have
to
a
go.
Boat, like, but...
No, no, he's going to swim, no. He's going to try and swim, you know.
Drive up to sea houses in the morning.
Oh, I see houses.
I think it's around about 10:30 they sail out, and they leave you on the island for about half an hour, then pick you up again.
Ah, you'll see the puffins.
That's right.
And the seals, and there's the kittiwakes, and
Okay, if you're into bird watching, it's a paradise for birds.
Well, it's just, so for some people, it's the nearest they get to going abroad. Up in Northumberland, you know.
Different little island, huh?
Oh, Farne Islands, Holy Island, Bangon, and St Mary's Island, and yeah. By Jove, we've seen the world. But it's
Coconut
nice.
Island.
Hey?
You can't land on Coconut Island, can you?
No, you're not landing on Kirkit. It's called Kirkit.
Kirkit. Kirkit. It took me ages to stop saying croquet.
So they don't take kindly. Up in Northumberland to be called croquet heads. Anyway, here we are. Good morning to you all. Good morning to you, Lord Ned.
Good morning, Michael.
And good morning indeed. Anyway, so if you're up the Farne Islands, Lord Ned will be in the prow of the boat, pointing stalwartly east as they head to the Farnes. Very nice. You should always try it. Go to the sea houses and the boats leave from the harbour there. I'm going to brush you for us, Ned, because I want to go sometime. I said, it's a few years since I've been up there, and I want to take the Mem Sahib and the Bairn. And it's wonderful. It really is wonderful. Especially when the boat capsizes. Anyway, 0191-477-2000. Well, what do you want to talk about? It's a new day. How do you want to talk about? Pick up the phone, give us a bell, like Peter has just done, the laddie. Peter.
Hello, Michael.
Good morning to you, Peter.
Good morning to you, sir.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. Have a fun. Right.
Yeah, I've just been listening to you on the wireless about masturbation.
Yes. I think Bobby Robson wants to sign him, but there's a bit of a difficulty with the Brazilian authorities.
Yeah.
But he's a right back.
Yeah, I think it's one of the most natural things what's good. Now, I think everybody, like you say, everybody's done it from the queen to the poof.
Copulation and masturbation, without them, obviously if we all masturbated and didn't copulate, then the world, you know, the humanity would die out. But they work in conjunction, hand in hand, so to speak.
Yeah, hand in hand.
But, obviously, I'm not going to ask you, I'm not going to belittle you by saying, have you done it? Of course you have.
Well, everybody's done it, Michael.
Yeah, I think so. The big argument is, did Jesus Christ do it?
Oh, who knows?
Well, he was the Son of God made man, and if he was made man, I presume he would have every manly function, and he must have gone to the toilet, must have had a wee.
Yep.
He's a man. And I'm sure he wasn't embarrassed by that, but Christians will be offended by what I'm saying. But he may well have copulated before, and he must have masturbated.
Yeah, well, I heard earlier on one of your callers was telling a story of about a youth who got caught masturbating.
By his parents,
yeah. Well, I got caught when I was 12, in fact.
Oh, now you're just showing off. Where are you from?
Pennywell.
Oh, Sunderland, Mackham. Right. Showing off, here we go, Pennywell.
Well, actually, I'm a Geordie, but I'm working over in Sunderland.
Oh, so it's even worse, really Geordie, probably from Benwell. So what happened?
Well, like you say, when you're kids, you get porn mags from your pals at school, and I took one home and opened the bedroom, sent to bed, under the quilt with the torch, the old torch there. And smacking the old monkey there.
Yes,
and I didn't hear my father come off. And of course, like, he pulled the sheets back and he goes, "Oi, lad, what the hell are you doing?"
Stupid father. What a stupid man your father was.
Of course, he's seen what I was doing. He says, "Oh, it's all right, son, it's all right." He says, because I was having a heart attack then. And he says, "Oh, it's all right, it's just a natural thing to do." And he says, "Don't let your mum see the porno mag." And he says, "When you finish with it, give us a look."
Yeah, that's a good dad. Except what he should have done was crept in, had a look, and then crept out. And give you a bit of... But, you know, dads can never do outright, usually.
Yeah,
but it is a thing. And what do you do if you're a dad and you creep into your teenage daughter's bedroom to say goodnight, and she's doing it?
Yeah.
You know, you see, it's not the same. You're, "Oh, well done, son, enjoy, sir." Yeah. You don't do that. So the thing is it's privacy. Yeah. People invariably want to do it in private. That's fair enough. See that, the blame of the privates. And then you just let people do it and don't cause a fuss. But there are some people who would want to bring the wrath of God down on you.
Yeah, I realise that. In fact, why I called you was there's a programme what was on last Friday on Channel 5 called Raw Sex. Mm-hmm. And when you want about masturbation, they even got clubs over in America where you can go and join and actually do it.
Oh, yes, yeah, where it's called mutual public masturbation.
Yeah, yeah, I've seen that on the television.
And, well, I didn't say that, but obviously there's nothing is in America especially. But there'll be people doing it in this. I mean, I've never felt the need to do it in company.
Yeah, yeah.
The bottom line is that if some people, if it's not hurting anybody, what the hell? I just wouldn't join a club and have a membership.
I
don't think I need to do that. I don't need a club, metaphysically speaking, to get off on it.
Yeah.
But it is, what I'm just trying to say is that it's there and it happens, and we've all done it, and I don't care who you are, grannies and granddads and young kids, and actually there are incidences of children getting sexually aroused at a very early age. It's just curiosity, it's pleasure.
It releases tension and everything.
Well, yeah, eventually it does. I'm sure that if you don't do it, you know, I'm sure that some of these priests who went in monasteries where there were total celibacy, which basically celibacy means not just having rumpy-pumpy with a woman, it also means not having your own one-handed rumpy-pumpy, so to speak. Well, neither wonder they would lash themselves with birches and prostrate themselves and cold baths. But they must have been gone up the bloody wall. And eventually, I think they drove them mad.
Yeah, on about this Ronnie Biggs, I'm coming back to England and that.
Well, he's in prison now, was it Ballyhaven or something?
Well, if I had been one of the Sun fellas what was bringing him back, I would have said, oh, fair enough, Ronnie, once you get into jail, we'll look after you, medical, no problem. We'll have a top doctor looking after you, a qualified geriatric, a doctor called Harold Shipman.
Oh, Dr. Shipman.
I think he would have been jumping out of plane and swimming. But
I think Dr. Shipman should be sent on the job. Hello, lad, Ronnie. I just want to have a little time with you here. Aye, Harold would have sorted out. But we've got him now. We're stuck with the bugger for the rest of his natural life.
Yeah.
And I still think Dave's suggestion yesterday was the best. Son, you pay the costs.
Yes,
you and it should happen. And I think everybody should write to the government and demand that the Son pay it.
I should do.
Or write to the Son and say, if you don't pay it, we're going to stop buying your paper. But I tell you, the Son's very clever, because the paper sales today and tomorrow and the next day will rocket up. And they'll manage this brilliantly, as they always do, and their sales will shoot up, their profits will be phenomenal. And the Mirror and the Express and the Mail are just sitting there like hungry kids outside the sweet shop with any money.
Right, nice talking to you, Mike.
Cheers,
right,
Peter. 0191-477-2000. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Yes, you know. I'm telling the truth. Oh, you know. George.
Yeah.
Where? What? What?
I'm here.
Oh, I'm glad. Didn't move around. How's it going, George?
Okay.
Good. Century Virgin, well, George. Never been on before, have you?
I've never been on before.
We'll have a fanfare. See, you're saying you've been on Century. You haven't been on my show. You haven't been on Century, Bunnyland.
No, I haven't.
Exactly. You've had a fanfare.
But I know you from the past, you see.
You know me from the past?
Oh, well, that's not what I was going to talk about, but I've got a confession to make, Michael.
I'm not a priest.
No, but I was the one that filled the bog in on Shakespeare Street.
You didn't?
I did. When I was working for the council.
George, are you by any chance of singing, George?
I am the singing one.
Hello, buddy lad.
Are you all right?
I am indeed. This is one of the funniest performers you'll ever come across. It's George, and his second name's just gone up my bloody head. George.
Part of the British Isles.
George. Oh, George, I'm sorry, mate. I've lost your second name.
Totally Welsh.
Georgie Welsh. George Welsh. George Welsh, a very great actor. If you ever see him, this guy's brilliant. Very funny. George, I'm sorry about that. Your name, I knew you were, and I just gone right out of my mind. I'm sorry, George. So, you filled it in.
I filled it in when I was on the council. It's full of dolomite.
What do you mean? What's dolomite?
Don't make little bits of yellow sandstone, limestone.
So if you would up the tarmac, right? And then then would be a slab. Then you'd pull the slab up, and then you've got to suck out all this dolomite.
Suck out all the stone.
And what if you did all that?
It would be beautiful.
The lavies are still there.
They're still there. There's not, I don't think there's any systems there now. But all the tile work was left.
Why did they do you, George? Why?
Because it was right inside the pub.
I know, perfect. I can understand. I can understand. I used it myself.
Our gang was the last one to use it.
Oh, of course. Hey, I hope you got a picture.
Hey, no, we didn't.
Oh, George Wells, I'm ashamed of you. I'm ashamed of you. So have you been gigging, son?
I've just come back from Whitby Moor and Coast.
Where?
I was Whitby Moor and Coast Festival.
Oh, Whitby, aye.
Was it good? Smashing.
Were you doing a spot in comparing, or?
I was comparing.
Aye, who else was on?
Jez Lowe.
Oh, Jez Lowe, aye.
John Wright Band.
Aye.
Oh, lots of people. It was good.
Why wasn't I?
I don't know.
Bloody Whitby. Sodom.
I've tried to get to, you know, I've dropped a few names in, like, for them, like, you know, just to...
You've got it, because they're from Yorkshire, man, they're thick.
Right.
So are you busy then, son? I'm not saying out of hand here, taxman or not, are you?
Still here and there.
You're still...
Odds and sods.
And it's not a lot of work, is there, though?
No, it's not.
You know, for quality.
There's bits of teaching and stuff like that.
Aye.
Funny.
Did you ever record that I Wish I Was a Viking?
No, I didn't.
Oh, that was a funny song, that.
It's a bit un-PC at this time of...
I saw it. I mean, see, if it was a CD of it, I'd play it. But very funny. This guy is very funny. Very clever songwriter. Very funny songwriter. And a lovely lad. And a great entertainer. And I haven't seen you for ages and pages, Jody Welsh.
I know.
Well, we're both alive anyway.
All right. Well, just
we're hanging in there.
My mum's cooking us a bit off at the minute.
Oh, bless her.
It's a soup, you see.
The broth.
Got people from South America coming in and dipping their spears in it.
Oh. these immigrants are everywhere, you know.
She's a funny woman.
She's had to be. Being your ma.
The funniest thing is, she's got wooden legs. But the funniest thing is, she's got real feet. One of them things you cannot understand.
No, it's a conundrum, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's what mothers are all about.
Aye.
Conundrum.
Well, I just thought I'd ring and tell
you
this
George,
the last one.
I'm going to give you another fanfare for being George Wells, but also being... The man working under orders from a higher authority, I understand.
Higher authority, what?
Because I'm sure you would have said we didn't want to fill it in, but they says you must fill it in. And Jody Wells, the man who filled in the Shakespeare Street gentleman toilet. And dig it up, your castle company Flynn, when you need him.
Aye.
Anyway, George, hope to see you around soon,
nice
mate.
To speak to you, Mike.
All the best, youngin.
Okay, now, bye.
Cheers, mate. George Welsh. Very funny, man. 0191-477-2000 to Judith.
Hiya.
Hello, darling. Welcome to the show of shows.
I'm a first-time caller.
You're a century virgin, my little plum duff.
Yes, I am.
So I have a fanfare.
You do well with your fanfares. You do well.
I do. My fanfares, they're all individually knitted, you know. Oh, yes, indeed. So where are you from, or do you want to tell us?
I'm not Bullen, I'm from Newbiggin-by-the-Sea.
Newbiggin-by-the-Sea.
Yes, and I think you know that town well.
I did. I opened the harbour deer.
The lifeboat right,
deer
yeah.
there. Yeah, and it gives
a good
big...
I couldn't get.
Give us a good big salmon. Frighten the life out of us. I thought, what the hell am I supposed to do with this? A bag of Welsh would have been nice. I didn't like salmon. And I took it home, I think I've told people, I took it home, took it down to Nashville's fish key and got it smoked. For a tenner, and then my mate Jody Boxer, we decided to we cooked it, and it was laid out on the kitchen table, and we went out around the Cumberland in Tynemouth for a drink, and invite some of us back for a big feast, and this cat got off the side of the bloody salmon, And there was, sadly, there was about 12 drunks chasing this bloody cat all over Icon Towers trying to nail it. And it got out and we had to bin the bloody salmon.
I'll tell you what it is, you're some sort of guy.
I've never forgotten you, Brigham.
Yeah, some sort of guy. I mean, I've just been telling the guy, and I've just lost my husband a couple of months ago.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. What was his name?
Alec.
Alec? Oh, and how long have you been together?
12 years. We've just celebrated 12 years.
Oh, God, he must have been young.
I lost him suddenly. I've got an investigation on the way, like, as we speak. But I'm not going to go into that. It's too involved.
Well, I'm very sorry to hear that. And East Alex, you know, and the life you had there, I bet it was 12 great years.
Good and bad, but we held it together.
Tax time, you've got to work at marriage. Yes,
I used to have to put my headphones on at night. Oh, you're not going to listen to that again, he would say. I'd say, I am, I like him. And I used to laugh. And he'd say, what are you laughing at? I used to say, you want to hear this guy, you know, so I can listen to you freely now, so... The wrong way, but never mind.
I'm sorry,
the radio beside us, and I was just saying to Guy, it's getting me through the night, because I don't like Monday nights, I don't like Tuesdays, I don't like Monday nights at all, this time of night.
Why? I mean, that's Little Lord Ned you were talking to there. By the way, give him his full title, Little Lord Ned Avecchi from the Third. Yeah. why Mondays? Is that a...
Well, it was the time of the phone call that we got to go into the hospital and get the shocking news. And the doctor just comes out with it. And then on the Tuesday he died, so I don't like Tuesdays, you know.
I understand that, but the easiest way is to think of the date he died. Right.
Well, do you know what the date is that he died?
What date?
Unlucky for some.
13.
Yeah.
Right. So you just think, well, once you think of it as a date, then the days don't matter. Because the date is there constant, and the days fit in underneath, so it can be a Tuesday, a Friday, a Saturday, a Sunday.
It is
the first thing.
Yeah,
and then bit by bit, you'll find that it's... And you're never going to forget, Alex. You're never going to stop the memories.
Oh, no, you'll never leave my heart.
But you will, you've got a life to lead, and he wouldn't want you any other way to go out and enjoy life. And be, because that's a celebration if you're enjoying your life. And I find it's, you know, bit by bit that, yeah, you remember him on that anniversary. I think you remember the anniversary you first met him, the anniversary you got engaged, the anniversary you got married. The anniversary you first went abroad. There's lots of anniversaries. You can all...
That's a lot of things.
Raise a glass to the lad. But don't start...
The only thing I am not looking forward to, when I was a long way away, but I'm certainly not looking forward to Christmas.
Yeah, have you got family?
We haven't, no.
Are you by yourself?
I am.
Really? No brothers, sisters or mums and dads?
I've got brothers and sisters, but I prefer to be on my own.
Why is that?
So I can...
So you can be a dutiful wife and mourn?
Possibly, yes.
How long is it since he died?
So I can cry in peace.
How long is it since he died?
13th of February.
So it's very raw still. Very, very raw.
Very.
But, you know, you've got to let that rawness start to heal. It's got to heal. Because you cannot live your life remembering Alex dying. You've got to start living your life eventually, remembering Alex living.
I try to, and that's what hurts the most.
It's going to take time.
You know.
And Christmas, when Christmas comes, I mean, so have you got any friends you work with?
Yeah.
Any single?
Quite a few starting to talk to us now.
I would find things to do, little things, but I would look out to try and come into contact with a friend, and maybe this Christmas... Maybe go away.
I think the hardest part is when you have to write a card out and you can't write your partner's name on it.
Right. Yeah.
You think, well, this is not happening.
Mm-hmm.
And things you sit down and you realise, my God, he's not coming back.
It's very, very near.
It's the hardest thing in the world.
I mean, say we are talking a few months. I've got to say that, bear in mind that you never ever forget the life you had with them. You do, it does ease up. And I think that in part is the way the mind works. Because
it's a funny thing.
But I always say, think on of the, all of life, but not now. I mean, say grieve. You're still grieving. That's still a time to grieve. But the and be selfish and grieve. You know, because your life's the less because of his death. So there's no wrong to be selfish about this. In fact, you know, death is the selfish, most selfish act that any individual can do to another individual, is to die on them. It's a terrible selfish act.
It is.
But that's, you know, you kind of blame them for it, but, you know, you've got to, your life has got to be led, and I would say that, you know, as you're getting through, you know, in there's the weeks, I think you need to talk to people. I think you need, there are, there are grief counsellors.
Yeah.
And I think that's wise to look at that. Your doctor will help you there to give you, just to talk and basically to talk to maybe a stranger, just about everything. And get the anger out. You should be bloody angry that a young man who you love has been taken from you. He hasn't wanted to go. You've never wanted to go. But this thing, we all die. Death's come early to you. But be angry about it too. There's no wrong with that. Oh, there's no.
I'm certainly angry. I'm saying to the guy there, you look at life in a different way.
Yeah.
It changes your life in a dramatic way, and you look at life in a different way, and you become bitter. You don't want to, but you become that way.
There's no shame. There's nothing wrong with that. It's all the grieving process is a multifaceted thing. You've got to go through all these. But I think if you're having a problem, go and ask your doctor and to about grief counselling, because that can help you. Right, and it you mustn't at times. I would think with you, at the minute, is that you maybe want to hold the whole burden on yourself. You don't have to. You can share the burden. This is sharing the burden a bit. This thing is sharing the burden.
I've been talking up the courage for a long time. I've heard your show many a times, and I wanted to come and see you at this. I've forgotten where you were. I couldn't remember where you were. And I wanted to come and see, and we drove by.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, oh, we've missed it, it'll be finished now. And I seen you on the television once, I think it was on Biker Grove, and I thought, hey, that's him.
Oh, I'll get everywhere. Don't shit.
But I used to have to put my headphones while I couldn't hear properly, so I've moved the radio tonight beside us, so I can put it on just at a low setting so I don't disturb the neighbours.
Oh, but I think
some of the things that you come out with are just... The whole of Century Radio through the day, the gags, is just, unbelievable, the gags.
They're the amateurs, Judy. They try the hardest, bless them. But you've got to come up here for the cream. The cream's always at the top.
Could I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Do you go to a pie shop in Tynemouth?
Do I go to a pie shop in Tynemouth?
Yes, or is it a shop where you get a pie from?
Oh, yeah, I've been to a pie shop in Tynemouth. In fact, I believe, if I'm right, there's about one, two pie shops in Tynemouth, isn't
there? Well, I went in and I said, is this the famous pie...
Oh, there used to be a great pie shop in Tynemouth that was run by Brian and Neville, homemade pies. But unfortunately, the good people of Tynemouth, the snobby buggers, didn't use it enough, and they had to close. So
I went in and I says, is Mike, the icon from San Diego, coming in?
Ooh.
Well, I'll have one of these pies.
Well, if it's the one near Walter Wilson's, always, it's usually, I usually get the meat and potato pasty. And very nice it is, but nothing can compare with Brian and Neville's, the time of the butchers in on Percy Park Road, which is no longer there, but they were the finest, wonderful, one of pies and sausages and meat, par excellence. But they're all snobby in Tynemouth, and they would stick their noses up. They'd far rather go to Morrison's and buy it wrapped, you see. And unfortunately, the shop shut.
Certainly makes someone laugh.
I tell you, so snobby in Tynemouth, when the shop was shutting, you couldn't move in the shop because they were buying the cheap meat, the bloody hypocritical snobs of Tynemouth. They weren't locking up. Anyway, darling, you know where we are. Anytime you like.
I'm lying a bit here. Just people be thinking, God, what's she laughing at?
I am annoyed because when they showed up, I lost me pies and sausages. I'm a very selfish person, and so do you. Think about the grief counsellor.
I know what you're saying, I know what you're saying. I'm under counsellors, to be honest with you. Yeah.
Any time you want, you come in here, and we'll have a go.
Oh, I'd love to.
Right.
I'd love to.
Okay then, babes, I've got to go now.
I know you have. Thanks for talking anyway.
We've got half an hour of this, and you've got the lovely Vicky Archer. All right?
Okay, thanks.
So you know where we are, Judith?
I do, certainly.
Don't take so long to phone up.
Oh no, well, I take so, you know, you feel a bit embarrassed, like, you know.
No, don't be embarrassed.
You don't know what to talk about and stuff like this.
You talk about how you want to talk
but
about.
But I've got a good sense of humour, so.
You're all right, kid. He's looking at you, kid.
Okay there, boys.
Okay there, boys. I'll give you a fan for that. 01914 Yes, I know. It was that little night. I forgot. Yes, yes. Go on.
On the same station. The biggest night to wake up to. 7 days a week. This is the North's biggest Century FM.
Right. Yeah, Charlie's a big fellow, all right, strong too. And because he exercises a lot, he's super fit as well. I tell you what, I'm glad he's my best mate. You can take it from me, nobody messes around with Charlie. He loves it when I roll him over and tickle his tummy.
With irons for large breeds, your big dog or puppy can also stay strong and active. That's because irons is scientifically proven to help promote healthy joints and cartilage in the breeds that need it the most. Irons, welcome to a new world of health. To reduce
accidents, what would you pay to drive what car's a state car of the year? What would you pay for outstanding style, performance and sheer practicality? Under £300 a month at your Volvo. The incredible V70 Torsland gives you saloon car comfort and refinement with estate car practicality. Outstanding luxury specification, including metallic paint, with real drivability to redefine what an estate car should be. And right now at your Volvo, driving one costs under £300 a month. Don't compromise. The Volvo V70 Torsland. What car estate car of the year is yours to drive away from under £300 a month at your local Millvolver. Test one today. Cash price £29.94, deposit £5.925, 1 month at £3.461, 34 months at £29.961, 1 final month at £3.4461, final option device 7393, total credit price £2.423.96, APR 9.66, ask for written details.
Clients contact us when they have decided to sell their with profits syndrome policy.
AccidentClaimsNorth.com. Maybe it's because they don't take a percentage of your damages, or they're based in the Northeast and only appoint local qualified solicitors who come to you, not unqualified agents who only deal on the phone. Or is it because they only operate a no-win, no-charge policy? If you've had an accident or want more information, call AccidentClaimsNorth.com on 3000-855-855 or visit our website. AccidentClaimsNorth.com. Taking your business, but not your. What we're doing for them.
Clients contact us when they have decided to sell their with-profits endowment policy. And have a surrender value.
I would say our clients trust us. That's why Robin Lloyd has been in business successfully for over 27 years.
When you make the initial inquiry with us, there is no obligation at all. You're not committed to anything.
Robin Lloyd Associates is regulated by the Personal Investment Authority.
We get a valuation on a policy between 3 and 5 working days.
Robin Lloyd are the endowment people.
We can get up to 30% more than the surrender value for them.
Our customers are always giving us positive feedback and telling us what a good job we're doing.
Charlie's
for them.
A big fellow.
The policy
right.
Needs to be over 6 years old, and because he is a profit endowment policy, and
well.
Have a surrender value of £2,000.
My best mate. You can take it from me. Nobody messes around with Charlie.
We have a website. The address is Robin Lloyd Associates. With
irons for large breeds, your big
Robin Lloyd Associates is regulated by the Personal Investment Authority.
That's because irons is scientifically proven to help promote healthy joints and cartilage in the breeds that need it the most. Irons, welcome to a new world.
Grand gag.
Mike the Mouth with Blue Line Taxis. Order a BLT now. The icon has landed. He's Mike the Mouth Elliott, and you can call him now. 0191 477 2000.
Hello, hello, hello. Hello, hello, hi. Joe.
Joe.
Hiya, Joe. It is indeed. How are you, son? Welcome to the show.
All right, but it's not Joe, really, like.
I didn't mind,
I'm sure from Southwick.
It's not Joe, it's Beryl.
Shove.
Is it, pardon?
Shove.
I know, but you just... you've just said the word, son. And you kind of say the... You kind of say it in any shape or form. You know, you swore. You kind of use the F word. Joe, you're a divvy. Whether you're Jody Shovelin's nephew, niece or what, you kind of use the F word. Divvy. So you dump head down, deep dive, deep, deep, deep down. Oh, what a pity. All that time you've been waiting, and I think it was about your fifth word. First tonight, though, a fanfare for that. But unfortunately, Joe, my boy, it comes over, and it's illegal. Illegal, man. So you dumped. You're into the pit of non-entity. That's where you've gone. And you may climb out of it tomorrow, Joe, and we'll talk. But you must not use the fur in any shape of fur form. Right? Or the k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k-k- Sure. Right? Otherwise, that's what you get. You get the big Dumbo. And without shame, I love doing it. I have got great fun and joy and pleasure doing the big Dumbo. But you are down. So, and if your Uncle Jody finds out, he's going to give you a good thrashing, and quite rightly so. Did I tell you that Chris Evans has married Billy Piper in Las Vegas? Yes, the ginger binge. Well, I don't know. The size of her, she wouldn't fit in me. She would fall through the leg of my wife runs. Not that I'd want her anywhere up there, I should tell you. Anyway, there you are. Let me see, will he do anything to revive his career? No. There'll be some daft radio station probably giving him a job. With that, he comes through, that capital have employed him. And I'm out. Oh, God, is there no life? Anyway, it's been fun, this show. We will do it again tonight, you realise, of a Tuesday. Hopefully we'll get rid of Bigzo. El Bigzo. The Bigzo the Bandit. He's in prison at the moment. But nobody wanted to talk about nationalise the oil companies or boycott Esso. Nobody has talked about religion cost you relationship. We've had a few talking about masturbating. And golf, well... I mean, is golf just a game for people who just don't know how to masturbate? I don't know. These are questions we ask on this show of shows. That's what it's all about. Surely there's good that you can see that. Paul.
Hello.
Hello, Paul. Welcome to the show.
Hello.
Hello. How's it going with you?
Not too bad.
Good.
Good as a hard time.
I'm sorry, Mr. Your girlfriend's giving you a hard time.
Aye.
In some cases, that could be a bonus, but why is she giving you a hard time?
She's hit the drink with her friend, with a vodka, and
her
smashes
me windows. Wait on now, do you live with your girlfriend?
Aye, but if I got a roof,
yeah. I
couldn't hit anymore.
So, wait on, she lives with you, how long have you lived together?
A year and a half,
and when did she start on the bottle?
A month ago, 2 months ago. Oh, 2 months ago.
2 months ago? One friend or two friends or what?
Three of them.
There's three of them gone out on the hoy.
Aye.
How many times a week?
She's gone there.
Anytime
with her friends.
Every night?
Aye, every night.
You should have tossed her out for bloody being. Not the cheeky Charlie.
It's a good bag of them and things.
Well, she would. But, I mean, he said she's living with you. She should be with you, not with her friends every night. So that's the first reason she deserves a bullet. The second reason, she's been getting drunk and they've been coming back in bad mouthing you, have they?
That's right. And make me look a bad lad. Make me look bad. As soon as I said, I'd get in my house. I didn't want you anymore.
And then, they've broke your windows?
No, she did. By the cupboards.
She already cupboard you?
Aye. Put your bottom in, aye.
And she didn't throw a bottle at you?
Oh, no. And I've got to get a new wind in.
Aye.
But she thinks she can smash the hoose up.
Well, you've just given her the bullet. Where's she now, like?
With her friends.
Well, that's it. Well, she likes to drink with her friends. She can sleep with her friends. Sodom. Go upstairs tonight, pack all her bags, pack all her drawers and frocks and blouses, put them in a suitcase and have them down, put everything that belongs to her, put it in a suitcase, down the bottom and wait for her. When she comes, say, there they are now, bog off.
Yes, but you're not coming here because she's had a drink.
No, she'll come round tomorrow sober and going, hey, I'm sorry, say sod off. Get your bags, you don't come back, we're finished. I'm going to find a woman who likes a drink with me, not with her friends, and who can handle a drink and disn't go and do lolly. Now, you've burnt your boat, bugger off.
Right, because last week she ran to my ma's door now.
Oh, she's a heat banger, man. Where's she from?
Spelling.
Well, there you are then, man. You shouldn't go out. Where are you from?
Big Gateshead.
Well, you're not compatible, Gateshead, lads. Felling lasses never works, man. You say you need somebody my style. I could control her because I'm an icon. But, she's not worth it. Just give her the pack of gear, shove it on the stairs and say, bye-bye. Take it and go. And don't let her even in the house. She can come in just to the front door, pick the bags and go. That's the way to do it, son. Do it for mankind.
Get it on, I'm the man. What's going on here? Oh, stop, I need me
inhaler. Making the Northeast laugh on the way home. The Baldy Brothers. Century FM. Proudly following Middlesbrough Football Club. Through the good times and the bad.
I am
Chris
Best, so wish all the
Clients contact us when they have decided to sell their with profits endowment policy. I would say our clients trust us. That's why Robin Lloyd has been in business successfully for over 27 years.
When you make the initial inquiry with us, there is no obligation at all. You're not committed to anything.
We get a valuation on a policy between three and five working days. We can get up to 30% more surrender value for them. Our customers are always giving us positive feedback and telling us what a good job we're doing for them.
A policy needs to be over 6 years old, so be with profit endowment policy and have a surrender value of £2,000. We have a website, the address is robinlloydassociates.co.uk.
Robin Lloyd Associates is regulated by the Personal Investment Authority.
What would you pay to drive Modcars' estate car of the year? What would you pay for outstanding style, performance and sheer practicality? Under Volvo, in credit, Volvo, 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 Volvo,
months at 61.6, 4 months at 61.1, final license by 7393, total credit price 243.396, APR 6666 for written details.
Dad, why are you still on?
If you're not looking for a mortgage, I'm sorry, but this could be quite dull.
I'd love to get away,
so
Fraser.
Concentrate on the music instead.
Too busy for a holiday in the sun.
If you are looking for a mortgage and you're hunting around for the right rate for you, try talking to Mercantile Building Society. They're local with branches and agents throughout the Northeast, and they're mutual. Oh, and you can call them for free at Mercantile Direct on 0500 295 500. And great. Right now they've got some great deals for first-time buyers. Give them a call. Mercantile Building Society. Call free phone 0500 295 500 for written details, or visit their website www.mercantile-ps.co.uk. Local, friendly, and quite interesting, actually. All loans are subject to valuation and status. Full written details are available on request.
Making the Northeast laugh on the way home.
Mike the Mouth. Blue Line Taxis. Order a BLT now. The icon has landed. He's Mike the Mouth Elliott, and you can call him now. 0191-477-2000.
Anywhere, anywhere, and everywhere, by Jove. It's nearly time your first day back. It's nearly time. This few hours' time, you'll be up the door. You'll be in the Foreign Islands in 10 hours' time.
Nice cup of tea before I go to bed.
Right, well, nice cup of wine. Tea. For you,
I'm going to have a cup of tea.
There's no wrong with a cup of tea. I have a mixture of teas now. I have mint teas and herbal teas and fruit teas and stuff like that. And they're very refreshing when I get up in the morning. I have them.
Well, I can't put a tea when I get up in the morning.
Now, I've got a traditional. I've got the Yorkshire born and bred, you know what I mean?
Street, I can't buy Yorkshire tea. I have Rington's.
Oh, Rington's is lovely. I have some Rington's tea bags, yeah.
Pay them last time they came.
Ah, you've got to pay them. That's a trouble. You know what they're doing, system.
Probably left it with a neighbour.
Anyway, enough of this badinage between you, Ned, and me, and we'll talk to Gordon.
Hello, Mike.
Hello, Gordon. Welcome. Good morning.
First time caller again.
Century Virgin, Century Virgin. Yeah. Gordon is a virgin. Well, there you go. You got your cherry box, right. Son. How's it going?
Thanks a lot. Do you mind if I talk about the Ronnie Biggs thing?
No, you talk about how you like.
I mean, they brought him back over here, and
the son brought him back.
Yeah, and they're saying sort of like, shall I put him away? Shall I not put him away? Put him away. Lock him up. Lock him up till he dies. Now.
Well, you cannot. You say. Well, you will. I mean, you say. But the point is, he's staying by because he's now a prisoner. He's. There is the normal humane things that we've always had in this country.
But
that
a hospital wing, isn't it?
He's in a hospital wing. He'll be, but he's had three strokes. He's got some paralysis, supposedly,
you know what?
And therefore, well, he'll have to be looked after.
He escaped from prison.
Yeah, but right. He'll still be left to looked after because.
Yeah, fine.
So it's going to cost you a fortune.
He's lived in Brazil all these years. Yeah. What is it, 30-something years or whatever?
No, not in Brazil. 30 years, probably about 20 years in Brazil.
Yeah. So he's been over there, right? He's took his money with him and all that. He's lived a life of luxury. Now he's a little bit skint. The son's going to pay him, what, £250,000, £500,000. So his family's going to be looked after. He knows he's dying. So he thinks, right, I'll come back over home, look after them.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
It's what a father would do for his family, he's done the right thing as far as the family's concerned.
And keep him locked up.
But the son should be made to pay for his time in prison. Mm. But he will be locked up. He's locked up now. And he's in a prison hospital. But it's going to cost a lot of money.
I mean, a lot of people say about that. I mean, you know, I am from up here. The accent might not sound it, but I am from up here. Right. I mean, I lived down in East London a lot of years, and a lot of people sort of like Barbara Windsor, for instance, about the craze and all that, let them free and all that. She never let them free. I mean, people say they only killed their own, but it wasn't just that they killed their own. Yeah, fine, they did. But it was the extortionate side of them the people don't look out, like the little shopkeepers down the road, give me a tenner a week, otherwise your place is going to...
Yeah, but I do think the Craze got, they should have been well in prison far too long. And
I think, I'm not saying they weren't.
You know, I think
they were murderers.
Yeah, but there were other murderers who did 15 years or 12 years, and you kind of just say, oh, you're the Craze, we don't like you, we're going to put you in longer.
Yeah, and I was just saying that as a respective, you know what I mean?
Oh, I know.
You know, people didn't
I know
say
the
about
East
the Craze,
I've hung around
there. The distortionate side of what they did.
I've talked to them down there, I've been in the Blind Beggar, and I've talked to people there in Whitechapel and that area who say, God bless them, they were lovely and all that, and the Craze of this and all. Partly because I think they never know who's listening in, and they still might get a good hiding if they slag off the Craze in them days. But the thing about Biggs, he will be in jail, whether he gets clemency, I don't know. I think he'll fall into the category like Myra Hindley. I don't think any politician will want to grant him clemency.
No.
Where he might have his chances, here in his appeal on the original sentence, but even if they're half it, he's still got 15 years.
Well, that's right.
I'll tell you what you can trust, he'll be riding to rescue the good old European court in the Hague.
Oh, yeah.
Let me tell you, there'll be barristers out there going, oh, no, human rights. His human rights is being denied. Not only should we cure him, we should send him back by private jet to let him spend his last years with his family in Brazil. The European...
Give him a few quid.
The European dimension, let me tell you, Gordon. OK?
Yeah.
01914 7 2000.
10 grand gag. Coffee's 10 grand gag. Coffee's 10 grand gag. Gag. On Century FM. Roger, on all of our region's roads, we have what's called a speed limit. Now, this is legal. Is there to prevent motorists? Other vehicles.
What would you pay to drive what car's a state car of the year? What would you pay for outstanding style, performance and sheer practicality? Under £300 a month at Bill Volvo, the incredible V70 Touslander gives you saloon car comfort and refinement with a state car practicality. Outstanding luxury specifications, including metallic paint, with real drivability to redefine what an estate car should be. And right now at Bill Volvo, driving one costs under £300 a month. Break the speed limit. Don't compromise. Volvo V70 Touslands, what car? State car of the year is yours to drive away from under £300 a month at your local Mill Volvo.
Your first home, your first mortgage. Today. How will you get the best deal?
Cash price 29.94, deposit fine 9.25, 1 month at 3.461, 4 months at 2.961, final month at 3.464, final option to buy 7.393, total credit price 2.433.96, APR 9.66, ask for written details.
I just need a little space to afford just short term, somewhere that's safe, secure and affordable.
It's all right, I understand. We can provide you with a 10-foot storage container from just £15 per week. Now, how does that sound?
Great!
Whether you need to store the contents of a whole house or just archive your office records, the Mobile Storage Group has the answer for you. Feel free to visit our new secure self-storage facility at Houghton the Spring, where we offer a quick and easy solution to your storage problems, with standard 20-foot containers costing just £20 per week, right up to a 40-foot jumbo at £40 per week. We are the Container People, the temporary accommodation and storage specialists. Call the Mobile Storage Group now on 0191-584-1992. That's 584-1992. The Mobile Storage Group. Storage solutions for the 21st century.
Clients contact us when they have to sell their with profits endowment policy.
I would say our clients trust us. That's why Robin Lloyd has been in business successfully for over 27 years.
When you make the initial inquiry with us, there is no obligation at all. You're not committed to anything.
We get a valuation on a policy between three and five working days.
We can get up to 30% surrender value for them.
Our customers are always giving us positive feedback and telling us what a good job we're doing for them.
A policy needs to be over six years old with a profit endowment policy.
And have a surrender value of £2,000.
We have a website. The address is robinlloydassociates.co.uk.
Robin Lloyd Associates is regulated by the Personal Investment Authority.
Robin Lloyd are the endowment people. It's about variety through your no-repeat workday.
Variety. This is the Northeast's biggest radio station. Mike the Mouth with Blue Line Taxis. Order a BLT now. The icon has landed. He's Mike the Mouth Elliott, and you can call him now. 0191 477 2000.
Hi, I'm John. How's it going?
Hi, Mike. How are you?
Not too bad. Good morning to you.
Yeah, listen, it was strange sitting here listening to my cousin on the wireless.
What?
George Welsh.
Oh, George!
Yeah.
The man who did that dastardly deed.
Oh, listen, when you get into number 10, right, when you move from Icon Towers to number 10, which is next move, obviously.
It should be next month.
Right. I want you to make him Minister of Culture.
He deserves it.
Because I tell you what, the whole country needs a good bloody laugh.
He is.
If anybody can do it, George can.
Well, I can as well, you know. I think people are forgetting that, you know.
George is he's a one-off, he's a man of his own, and he's a great kid. Well, he is compared to me.
God bless you, George, listening there, chuckling to himself.
I want to grass him up.
Go on.
Right, when George was young, right, he was really into heavy metal music. Tyrannosaurus Rex and all these things. He used to get his guitar out and say to me, what do you think of this? And I go, ugh. And he's really developed and he's a great lad. And
he's come up from Trex, that famous band.
That famous band that greases all parts of the bits can't reach.
it was a lovely joy to hear him, because I haven't seen Geordie for years.
He's a wonderful person. If half the world were like him, it would be a better place.
Christ almighty, mad as a hatter. Thank you, John. I've got to go. I've got to finish the show. Cheers, John. There you are, Geordie. That's your lot now. No more personal testimonials. Keep your testimonials to yourself. Anyway, because it's nearly time for me to Ganyam, you know, and little Lord Ned as well. And Vicky to come and entertain you and give you all the news. There she is. Vicky Archer Jones comes in with one of them looks that you just think,
What have I been up to?
She's been up to something.
You've been sat in the booth. That's all.
Are you all right, dear?
I am so full of cold. Oh. It's untrue, so I need lots of tender loving care tonight.
Tender loving care. My God, I wonder my lips are starting to sting. It's the Vic. I'm getting bombarded with Vic rays. Oh, well, look. So, always look after the lovely Vicky as she entertains you womanfully. Is that right? Womanfully?
It'll do me.
And so don't go heavy on. She'll still entertain you. It's great, great, great songs, great show. All the way through, 6 o'clock or 7 o'clock?
6 o'clock.
6 o'clock, right, so it's 6 o'clock. And then she'll tell you what's happening on Century, Goffey and Mark Thorburn and the Barley Brothers and the football legends and Paula Chantrell. I'll be back with Ned on Tuesday night of 9 o'clock, is that right? Say bye-bye, Ned.
Bye-bye, Ned.
There you are, that's
bye-bye,
little
everybody.
Old Ned. And we will be seeing you all as well. Thanks for everybody phoning in, thanks for listening. Pick up the phone and give us a bell, you know where we are, 0191 477 2000. Remember, Goffey's still got money up for grabs there on the where and what. Ooh, 6:30, 7:30, 8:30. And of course, Goffey's 10 grand gag is still going. 0191 477 5660 is the fax. 0191 477 5660. Fax it. Email goffey@centuryfm.co.uk. That's the email. Email for Goffey. goffey@centuryfm.co.uk. Get your gag in. Until then. Bye, don't be heartaches. Yes, indeed. And all you will be doing is enjoy yourself. Oh, hello, love. I'm going to hand you over to an invalid. Good morning till tonight. Ta-da.
Some newspapers under investigation by the Press Complaints Commission for its part in the Ronnie Biggs return to Britain. The newspaper chartered the private jet used by the great train robber to fly home from Brazil. It also made payments to Biggs and some of his associates, raising a number of issues under the newspaper code of practice. But Peter Preston, the former Guardian editor, says the paper will insist it acted in public interest.
The Sun will argue that without that payment, Biggs would still be in Brazil, a wanted criminal. Scotland Yard would still be wasting money trying to persuade him to come home, and justice would not have been done.
Police in Cambridge fear that a lethal high-dose version of ecstasy is being sold in the city. It follows the death of a university student, that's Lorna Spinks, who died in hospital yesterday after collapsing in a nightclub. Catherine Feast from Cambridgeshire Police says this batch of the drug is extremely dangerous.
She's been out for a night out. She's taken what we understand is ecstasy, and it does seem to be an enormously strong tablet, and we are very concerned about the circulation of these tablets. Anybody who's got any of these tablets, please do speak to police, hand them over. Do not take them.